all Southwestern Conference tackle, Maceo Pfeiffer, 6'6", 263 pounds, and he can really block off the line of scrimmage. Here comes the fear with Maceo Pfeiffer. And now a quick look at the Oklahoma Sooners. Darrell Shepard, who runs the Oklahoma wishbone and runs defense, is completely ragged. Shepard averaged over 6 yards a carry and crossed the goal line 13 different times. He used to play at the University of Houston before transferring. And Stanley Wilson is the other object of Coach Barry Switzer's affections. Only 156 carries, over 1,000 yards, a 6.5 average, and he played in only 9 games. Yes, like Washington and Sims and Owens, Stanley Wilson is only a junior and is one of the greats. And up front, the two-time All-American at guard, his name is Terry Crouch, a 275-pounder. He's an earth mover. Watch the wishbone left guard. Great. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to beautiful El Paso, Texas. It is sunny in the high 60s, a gorgeous day with contrails going above us with the airliners. I'm Tom Brookshire, and I was born and raised right down the road in Roswell, New Mexico. And with me is Hank Stram, not only a great professional coach, the Super Bowl champions with Kansas City, but also a great college coach. And welcome to the Sun Bowl.
Well, it's been a great week, hasn't it?
It has been a great week. Now, listen, let's talk first. Oklahoma, everybody knows. Switzer in 9 years has either won or tied the Big Eight Conference, 8 of those 9 years, 2 national championships. But we don't know a lot about the Houston Cougars. What about the team?
Well, I think basically people around the country know about the Southwest Conference. They immediately think that probably the University of Texas and Arkansas are the winningest teams in that conference. That's not true. In the last 6 year period, since the Houston team has been in the Southwest Conference, they have won the conference championship on 3 occasions. They have won more games than anybody else in the Southwest Conference over that 6 year span of time. Bill Yeoman invented the veer. He's one of the great coaches in college football, along with Barry Switzer. We're going to see a great football game here this afternoon.
Of course, Oklahoma's the number one rushing team with 343 yards a game. That's going to be tough to stop. Our colleague on the sidelines, the former professional great with the Rams and, of course, the Giants, is Freddie Dreyer. Freddie, let's go down the sidelines right now.
Well, who said you had to go to Palm Springs to get any sun, Tom? They're crazy. I got him right here. As well as all those important sports interviews for you the rest of the day right down here on the sideline.
All right, we'll be checking with Freddie. He's with the Omegle man. Don't forget that Oklahoma and Houston have never played one another, nor are they scheduled to down the road. So this is a recruiting war right here at the Sun Bowl. It's going to be really a good football game. Or maybe a yard or so. Number 80 is Brian, a sophomore who has just been a whirling dervish for the Oklahoma defense. 245-pounder.
You know, Tom, and really, I think the reason they sent Mark Ford in motion that time, he is not overly large from a weight standpoint. He weighs 210, and I think they felt if they move him in motion, maybe he could get more of an advantage on the linebacker, plus release downfield a little quicker.
Good point. We've got a good, fast AstroTurf here in the Sun Bowl. Third down and short. The flags are down. Lionel Wilson barely even got that handoff made, if he did, on the ride that time.
I think Pfeiffer that time, the right tackle was offside.
Alan Polk was the carrier. The officials, by the way, are from the Southeastern Conference, so there cannot be any kind of partiality laid on them. James Harper Jr. is the referee you just saw. Jack Smalley. George Morris is the linesman.
Offense, refused.
Eddie Dudley is the line judge. William Stanton, the field judge. And Dick Pace is the back judge. Refused. So the first punt now by Lonnie Stokes.
Tom, you did a pretty good job of running down from the top of the rope and made it 1-3. I thought sure you'd be wearing low cuts instead of those cowboy boots.
We only had 90 seconds. It was a race. Albert Watts, a very dangerous punt returner, is waiting back. He's got the fair catch signal call. Now lets it bounce, which is still legal. Hits the turf and bounces almost into the Houston bench. The red jerseys worn by Oklahoma means that they are the host team. So they got to pick the red of the Sooners. And if you've ever watched a college football game in These United States, you know, Oklahoma plays football, but they don't throw it much. Do you think they have to today, Hank Stram?
Their personality is such, they don't want to throw the football. They're concerned about not getting in a third and long situation. They want to be third and three. They've averaged five passes a game. They completed 41 for the entire year. They completed more passes in a pregame warm-up today than they have all season.
The offensive line, by the way, averages 265 pounds from tackle to tackle. It is gigantic. That's the reason they can run. Here's the wishbone. Good handoff. Looks like Stanley Wilson coming off the right side, and he got hit hard. The third-best total defensive team in the NCAA ranks this year, the University of Houston.
And Weedy Harris, that time number 51, really did a great job on the defensive viewpoint.
Kelly McDonald, Callaway, the young man that played so well this year, McGallion at the nose, Terry Monroe, and of course on the outside, Weedy Harris and Grady Turner, two linebackers, and a secondary that has 25 interceptions, Laquan Vonner, Love, and Easton. Here's the first pass, overthrown, trying for number 82. Pass there by the young man who used to play at the University of Houston. He transferred, and the first time he touched the ball for the Sooners in 79, he went 40 yards for a touchdown. But you know, interesting about that, Yeoman let him transfer knowing that he could never go into a bowl, right?
And I think maybe he felt he was going to get him anyhow, so that's why he said
that
he didn't.
Here it is on third down, and call it 8 yards. Ooh, option, good defensive play by Terry Monroe, the big right tackle, the 255-pounder. Big penetration. That's the one thing the Cougars have done. They tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
They get a good picture of Monroe, the defensive right tackle, number 99, leaking through there and making the tackle. A beautiful spot.
Those were massive offensive tackles. And now back to punt, of course, is Keeling, who does both the punting and the kicking, the field goal kicking. End-over-end kick taken at the 15-yard line by Darryl Jackson. Not too much on the run back. And both teams have volleyed back and forth. And no one has drawn any blood at all yet. The wishbone against the Veer. Houston against Oklahoma. And boy, it's a gorgeous day for football in El Paso. The Sun Bowl, 12:48 left in the first quarter. Now let's go to Freddie Dreyer on the sidelines. Fred.
Tommy, that last set of series, that last series for the Oklahoma Sooners was a tough one. They're going with the wind. However, the wind is really swirling down here on the sideline, and the last pass they threw really took off. They'll probably stay on the ground.
Okay, Fred, nobody knows better than the great defensive end for the Rams. There's Old Glory. A little breeze. Trying to Wilson's toss. Back to Alan Pope. The Pope has some yardage. Picks up about 7 yards. A good-looking option play by Lionel Wilson, the quarterback.
And the pitch was just a little bit behind Alan Polk that time. He did a good job of reaching back and making the reception. Watch him. Does a good job of running to the outside. Puts the ball away from pressure in the left hand. And does a good job of running down the sideline. Makes a nice gain on the play.
He's the senior. They said as a sophomore and junior, maybe the best running back they've had there in years. And he got a knee injury. And he's still playing extremely well. That time he picked up 8 yards. To the right side now. Wilson keeps the ball. Makes the first down and gets almost to the 40-yard line. Lionel Wilson now is 204 pounds, 6'1", runs a 9.600. Think about that one from Jones High in Houston. Talk about a great athlete. The starting quarterback went down in the Miami game, and this young man took over, and from then on, it's been nothing but big numbers.
And he looked like he was going to get tackled that time for a loss, but in spite of that, he stretched the loss into a gain and picked up the necessary yardage for the first down. A beautiful run, a short run by Wilson, the quarterback.
He might be one of the best athletes to play quarterback that we've ever seen if he works on his passing. The inside counter, handoff to number 43. That's Dwayne Love, I believe, that's in there. Mary, I think that's Durham. Robert Durham, as Yeoman will try to move five or six different running backs in. There's the coach right there, sending one in. The play goes in with the player right there. And the young people that play for him at the University of Houston really like him as a person. He's intelligent, he's sharp, and he's a stable man, sort of a good father figure for young people.
What do you say, Barry?
There's Barry Switzer on the sideline. Nobody can be as successful as this man in 9 seasons. It's just an incredible percentage, 866 on the win column. Down call, straight dive, and the toss passes, juggling and then caught by number Mark Ford, the big tight end, caught that ball.
Yeah, he made a great catch. He was right
twice
back.
Twice he caught it.
Well, he wasn't. That's right. It was a double dip shot. But that time he pierced the zone, went right down, didn't have anybody on him whatsoever. It was a play action fake. And he went right down into the seam. There wasn't anybody in the hole. He popped it up in the air, caught it, came down with it. Mark Ford, number 91, 6'4", 210. A nice-looking play.
Lionel Wilson had 9 touchdown passes. Here's the reverse handoff inside to Durham again, number 43. Not much that time as Bryan stopped it up. And that Shipp, the young linebacker for Oklahoma, he led the Big 8 in tackles with 179 tackles. Sophomore.
And that time they ran a trap, Tom, a trap option with the left guard, number 73, Scott Marshall, trapping on the play. They didn't succeed in making much yardage on the play, however, but that's the variation of things they do.
You don't think that you trap much out of this kind of a formation, but they somehow get it done, huh?
Yes, they do, and those big, strong linemen up front do a good job of making something happen.
Second down 10, the first good drive by either team. Here's the reverse handoff. Now the pass by Wilson again. It's caught. That's Mark Ford, the senior who's made so many big catches for this team this year. Boy, he looked like a little touch on that pass. That was nicely thrown.
Yes, and you know, you have to be like a ballet dancer to play quarterback for both of these teams. A reverse pivot, a fake, and it made it look, he faked the trap that time, just like he ran on the preceding play. A trap option that time came down the line of scrimmage and threw the ball to the tight end, Mike Ford. But you really have to be a great athlete to do those kind of things, and this kid really does them extremely well.
First down. Keep in mind that the clock does stop when the first down is made and they move those chains. 10:45 left in the first quarter, and the Cougars are driving. Back inside, not a lot. Miami beat this team early in the season with 4 field goals. And later on, they lost to Texas A&M by a point when they missed the 2-point conversion. SMU gave them a pretty good going over, and they tied the University of Texas in a game they thought they should have won.
Well, I think everything that happened to this team was self-inflicted.
It caused their own destiny, huh?
Yes, that's right.
A good-looking young team, that's Lionel Wilson. Here's the inside handoff. He's trying to throw it. He's being blitzed and dropped. Number 25 came up very quickly for the University of Oklahoma.
Gary Lowell did a good job of coming up and making the tackle. And, you know, that time, you know, that kind of thing takes an awful lot of time. Every run and every pass looks the same. That's the secret of their success. They want to make sure that everything looks the same. There's good acting on the part of the run and the pass. That time he faked to his left and tried to roll to his right. But by the time he got there, number 25, Gary Lowell, did a good job and made the tackle.
A safety blitz. I didn't think we would see those kind of things in college ball. I like it. Okay, a third down, and call it 7 yards to go. 17 yards to go, pardon me, following the set. Good handoff, dumped out in the flat. A good run by Alan Polk, who is a real good pass receiver, plus being a gutty inside runner. That time he took it on the dead run, a good throw, and picked up. Well, it's going to be close to the first. Let's see.
And that was nothing more than just a regular play-action fake, and he got the ball over the top of the line, the right tackle, Bob Slater, who was getting penetration, dumped the ball on the outside to Alan Polk, and he gets down there close.
It's going to be fourth and call it 5. And the field goal man is in, the barefooted one, Mike Clendenin. He won 3 games kicking field goals. He only tried 2 in his whole high school career. Just be learning. This is up. It's long enough. Is it inside? It looks awfully good. It's no good. It's just off to the left. Just off to the left. And out to the 20-yard line. The ball will come, and the Oklahoma Sooner defense did rise to the occasion. The Cougars got it moving, but it ran into a rock. Oklahoma's going to be on offense. Boy, here's a young man. It's only a junior out of Carson, California. I don't know how he ended up at Norman, but I'm sure that Switzer had something to do with it. What an athlete. He's got 1 more year left. He's in some top categories with some great people. 196-pounder with a 9.5 speed we return.
Yeah, and he reminds me a little bit of William Andrews, a great fullback for the Atlanta Falcons.
Good point. Second down and 3 as Wilson picked up 7. Here's the inside fake and give to Wilson. And that's the key. That's the key to that wishbone is, does he give it to that fullback or does he ride outside an option? And remember, the Aggies have not faced a wishbone team since, or Houston hasn't faced a wishbone team since 1978 when they played the Texas Aggies.
Well, they're going to have to catch up in a hurry in this game because this team runs it so well. And there was a great illustration of it that time with the fine fullback Stanley Wilson popping through there on the left side. Good blocking at the point of attack by Ed Culver and Terry Crouch, the offensive left guard number 75.
And the Sooners get it rolling with the bone, as they call it. Here's the counter move and the option play. A fumble, and that's been the Oklahoma problem, but maybe it was re-recovered by Oklahoma. Let's see. They fumbled 30 times, lost 30 fumbles in 52 shots this year. Alvin Ross came up with it.
And they feel that if they don't tumble the ball on the terrain often in a game, they can beat anybody. They already lost games rather than get beat because they fumble so much, as you mentioned, 52 times and lost 30.
Man on the spot.
You know, the amazing thing.
Harris made that tackle. There's a man, Alvin Ross, from Aurora, Illinois. 40 of 65 players for Oklahoma are from out of the state. They're going to get the best ones. Here's Shepard. He doesn't throw a lot, but he does this time. Overthrow, spike, and almost intercepted. There's a flag on the play.
We're going to see some pass interference on the play, I think, Tom. Defensive back interference, pushing.
Butch LaCroix was in there to make the play. In this secondary for Houston, they do ball hawk, but that time it looks like they may have gotten caught.
You know, Oklahoma, it's amazing. In 11 games, they've only completed 41 passes.
First down.
They've only completed 41 passes?
41 passes for the year.
More fumbles than passes. That is an interesting stat. This time it goes for a first down just into Houston territory.
First and 10 on the Houston 49.
Inside play. Number 32, you're used to him by now, Stanley Wilson. He danced to the 42-yard line. He hits that hole very quickly. How do you try to stop the bone, Hank? What is the big objective, stopping the fullback to start with?
Yeah, you have to assign a man on the fullback, the quarterback, and the tailback, which means really that you have to have man-for-man coverage in the secondary. And Houston is playing some eight-man line, making them force them to trying to throw the ball rather than just run it, because that's what they do best.
Here's Wilson again. He's got the first down before he's knocked back. Let's go down to Freddie Dreyer on the sidelines.
Tom, what you might start seeing in Houston doing is running a lot of that eight-man line, a lot of people up on the line of scrimmage, and blitzing, a lot of blitzing today against Oklahoma. I don't think they're going to be passing that much into the wind. So back to you.
Okay, Freddie. And as you said, the eight-man line, they will force young Shepard to throw, and that's not what he likes to do.
No, they're going
to
say, well, listen, you run the ball so well, we're going to make you play another game. We're going to make you throw the ball to beat us. And that's what they're trying to do with the eight-man front and with all the stunts that are going on. Very intelligent approach, incident.
Wishbone call on the first down. A fumble. Looks like that Oklahoma recovered it again. Looks like they, Jeff Williams, or the big tackle, number 78, the one that came up with that.
Second and 10.
And that time they ran an inside belly play, meaning that they faked the ball to the fullback, a good ride, and then they give it to the halfback to the left side, and that's what you call a belly play, inside belly play.
Two fumbles already in the first period for Oklahoma. They've recovered both. But unless you fumble them forward for a long way, it's hard to keep drives going. Now it's second down and 10, and the young man may be forced to throw again. That's Shepard, the quarterback. Hand off to Wilson inside. Gets inside the 35-yard line and ends up on the 42.
That time, I think, Tom, they were in an unbalanced line, meaning they had an extra lineman on the left side to give them more strength. I don't know why in the world they need it with that big offensive line like this. You know, that line is bigger than the one we had in Kansas City with those great linemen we had with Jim Tyre, Ed Buddy, and David Hill, along with Mo Mormon.
Well, that big Byford, number 75, used to weigh 300, and they trimmed him down to 275. He took up about three chairs at the luncheon the other day, the Sun Bowl luncheon. All right, third down and 5. Will Shepard throw it? He's going to option to the weak side of the formation. A good-looking runner. Oh, he's down to the... He's going to score a touchdown. Shepard scores again, his 14th touchdown of the season. He is slippery. He's not big at about 185 pounds. Some athlete from Odessa, Texas. A blue chipper, they called him.
And I tell you, the Alvin Ross, number 34, I don't know whether we'll see it or not, but there he is. He makes a beautiful block, which enables Darrell Shepard to go inside, maintains his balance, breaks into the open, goes into the end zone, touchdown, Oklahoma.
Holding his number 7.
Over 700 yards rushing for the little man that used to play at the University of Houston before transfer. He was supposed to be a marked man today. It's good. Oklahoma on top. running the football, fumbling a little bit, but keeping it going and using their great little quarterback to score. It's 7-0.
The last time they played, and they're playing as good as anybody in the league on defense right now.
All right, it's going to be a big one. We'll be there to watch it, right? We're getting the flight right after this game, and we'll be back there. I'm going to sit in the stands like a normal homo sapien, you know, and just watch it with the people.
Well, I'm going to do the game for radio tomorrow with Jack Buck, so we're looking forward to that encounter.
There the yards gained, 80 yards on 9 plays, and, of course, the 34-yarder in a hurry by Shepard. Keeling is the kicker. He's 6'3". They're going to have to hold it on the tee. Nice breeze is blowing right toward Mexico. Boy, what a beautiful time these players have when they come down. And there's young Keeling. Seldom used. He didn't punt much this year because they kept running the football down people's throats. Here's the key. That's Jordan back to take it. It's out of the end zone and almost in Mexico. He missed the ambulance by a foot. So now we'll see if the Cougars can come back. They're going to be throwing against the wind if they decide to go that way. They don't have the real big running back, do they, Hank?
No, they don't. They have good speed, but they don't have a big, strong guy, a sledgehammer back. And, you know, talking to Bill Yeoman yesterday, he indicated that they've averaged about 14 passes a game. Thought maybe they might throw about 25 today, depending if the wind conditions were proper.
Here's the reverse roll by Lyle. He wants to throw it. Now he doesn't miss. He keeps it. Gets to the 26-yard line. He's run out of bounds.
Boy, did you see the great block by Lonel Fee that time? Boy, terrific right on the sideline.
He's a pretty good pro prospect, isn't he? At one time, he had 4.3 speed for the 40, and now he's probably slowed down to 4.4 or 4.45.
Yeah, he's a lightning guy. He's 5'10", weighs about 170, and he's a senior. And I think everybody feels that he's going to be a good pro.
He'll catch it coming across the middle. That's one of the things they say about Fee. It's important if you're thinking about pro ball. Pickup of 6 yards by Wilson. He's going to keep it this time, and options at the outside. That's Alan Polk takes it. A good option and lateral that time. The quarterback has to wait till the moment of truth before he unloads.
Yes, and you know, a quarterback in this kind of an offense is very much like the old tailback in the single wing and the short punt, Tom Brady. He has to be a great athlete, has to be able to run, has to be able to pass, and he has to claw for extra yardage just like the Cougar right there.
That's Shasta, the Houston mascot.
Yeah, he's going to be the number one draft choice, I think, at Cougar.
He can play the secondary, I'll tell you that. Third down and one, short yardage. Let's see what Oklahoma does. Make a good play, get penetration, a bad toss outside. That is a lateral. It's taken. He's going to be close to it. Alan Polk took it on the double bounce. Looks like he might have picked up the first down. Good force by that time by the Oklahoma defense.
You see the nice flat lateral. He made the ball bounce flat instead of on the point. He could have thrown him upside down, and we'd have been in trouble. See, but nice and flat, bounce right up.
Excellent. Put that one in the playbook.
You really got to work on that kind of a play a lot to get the timing down in practice.
A first down for the Cougars. It's not how you get them, if you get them, I suppose.
And as long as you advance, you got a chance.
Lionel looking around now. He won't do much play changing, but he's going to throw this time back to left side, intended for Fee, overthrown a little bit.
You know, the two outside receivers at that time were one and one. The defensive backs were playing about 12 yards off of both receivers. This side, the defensive back was playing very tight. He threw it to the tight side, threw it to the wrong person. Had he thrown to the right side, he would have had a big gain had he thrown it properly, of course.
Okay, Coach, I'll take your word for that. 4:45 left in the first period. The Sooners, in this battle for recruiting honors, not only in the state of Texas but elsewhere, is what they're playing for. Both teams would rather win their conferences, of course, and decide to play it all out today anyway. Long call by Wilson. Reverse now, spinning out the throw. It's knocked down by Byron. A young defensive lineman for Oklahoma somehow got his arms up, and he's working against Pfeiffer, who's a load.
I think Pfeiffer hit him, and he jumped up in the air and made the play, a good-looking play by Rick Bryan, 6'4", 244, sophomore.
He just took a whack to it, five as he went by. There he is, only a sophomore. Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Stayed right home and has played in a great tradition of great linemen that have played with the Oklahoma University Sooners. The option pass thrown short and away. Pinkert, Roberson, I believe, on the outside, but looked like the tight end got in the wrong way.
Both of them were in the same area. And here again, I don't think people really understand and fully realize what a great responsibility is to be a quarterback on a wishbone team or a veer team, because he has to do so much faking. Footwork has to be so good, and unless he comes out of the spin properly and the footwork is good, he has a very good chance of throwing the ball poorly.
But then he will have to watch it. And waiting for it will be Albert Watts. Watts has had a 62-yarder earlier in the year. And the wind will be just a little bit in the young man's face. He kicks it. It's a wobbly kick being fair caught for by number six. That's Hayworth over there who made the fair catch. We'll have the football for Oklahoma. Following the Sun Bowl, stay tuned as CBS Sports brings you NCAA basketball action. Denny Crum's University of Louisville Cardinals takes on the great one, of course, the 40-year coach at DePaul, Ray Myers, DePaul Blue Demons. Two teams loaded with talent right here on CBS NCAA basketball. That's right after the Sun Bowl, and we got a doozy going. 4:34 left in the first. Cuts back inside. Shepherd gets to the 45, maybe the 46-yard line. Boy, he's quick.
Yeah, he makes something happen. And the other great thing that's so important with a quarterback like the ones we're seeing here this afternoon, they have to be very decisive. They have a lot of decisions to make. They have to make the right one. He made the right one that time. And again, they were in an unbalanced line to the right that time, Tom. They got an extra man on the right side. They got a little extra power. And they're doing a good job of moving the football to that side.
And they keep pulling that Terry Crouch, that 275-pound guard, when they do that from that formation sometimes. Here's the inside handoff. A fumble. Recovered, it looks like, by the University of Houston at the 41-yard line. It is. Stanley Wilson coughed the ball up. Remember now that Switzer has said it's not in our ball handling where we fumble. It's because our runners are trying for extra yardage all the time. Bonner came up with it, the safety man.
Well, he got a couple of good hits from both sides that time. They jarred the ball loose, and Bill Yeoman indicated last night on his TV show, said that really it isn't the system that creates the fumble, it's the hard hitting of the defense, and there was a good illustration of what happened on that last play.
Big turnover. Back off top, and almost intercepted by Benson, the young sophomore linebacker who had his hands on it. Ball will throw a little bit wild. There's Benson. Benson and Shippen, there are two sophomore linebackers that are just wrecking crews. And they are sophomores. Keep that in mind. Oklahoma team next year is going to be loaded for anybody, I guess.
They're loaded all the time.
This time they're loaded with sophomores.
Yeah, and it's lightning right and lightning left. They can really fly.
Second down at 10 now. Lionel Wilson is the quarterback. He's having trouble throwing, just finding the receiver. They see, here's the option play, and fumbled. And then recovered going out of bounds. Wiggins made a double catch and almost lost his jersey. Someone's got to redress him. Freddie Dreyer, you got something down there?
I believe so. Standing on the sidelines, I noticed a lot of enthusiasm at that last fumble recovery. The coaches were saying that all they needed was a break. Maybe that fumble was a big break. We'll turn it around for them offensively.
Freddie, of course, speaking from the University of Houston sidelines. If he says that on the other side, it'd probably be a riot.
Listen, John Truitt that time, number 41, did a good job of coming up and making a play.
Now we got a passing situation. Third down and 12. Roberson is a young man flanked to the top of your screen. He's coming back for Fee, coming across the middle. In and out of the hands. The ball might have been too hot to handle, but it looked catchable from here.
We had a couple of great players from the University of Houston play for us in Kansas City. Elmo Wright, who was really a super flanker receiver. Here we see the inside move by Fee. The ball's a little high, but he should have made the catch.
He doesn't drop those very often.
No, not very often at all. He's a good one.
Keeling is in now.
And we also had a great running back, Warren McVay, who really popularized his rear offense.
Albert Watts waiting for a advantage kick. It bounces. 34, it's down there. And Oklahoma will put it into play. And look at that offensive line come on the field. It almost tilts.
They'd be good in the Canadian League because they need a wider field to play on.
Young Shepherd transferring from the University of Houston when the NCAA had some violation, or they thought they did. And he's now playing against his old teammates. Next Saturday, Tampa Bay at Dallas on CBS. Next Sunday, Philadelphia or New York in San Francisco at Candlestick against the amazing 49ers. All that right here on CBS. Wilson out over the 40-yard line and very quickly.
They're playing with an unbalanced line again, Tom. They continue to stay in the unbalance left and right. That time unbalanced line to the left. They ran back to the weak side.
Grady Turner made the tackle. I didn't remember seeing an unbalanced line on the highlight stuff that we looked at of all our different games. Did you notice it during the year?
Yes.
You did notice it?
Yes. Noticed it in the pictures the other day, yes.
I set you up for that, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
There's the coach.
You done good there.
Two national championships in 9 years for Barry Switzer at Oklahoma. That's tough to beat.
That time he was normal.
Wilson gets hit behind the line, still gets out to the 45, but good penetration by McGallion, the nose guard. That is also a young defensive team playing for the Cougars. They didn't really think they were going to be as good a defensive club as they are.
No, and they came on like gangbusters, as you mentioned earlier in the game. They're the third team in the nation on defense. Boy, that's really quite an achievement.
And third overall, which is rather remarkable when you think you've got a lot of sophomores in there. Third down and one. Now you find out against the best rushing team in the country.
Unbalanced left.
Oh, hit behind the line is Wilson. Grady Turner caught him as he got the handoff from Shepard. Some play.
He looked like he was in the huddle that time. Well, the Oklahoma team, the way he came across there and made the tackle, 6'2", 16 from Tyler, Texas.
That's where Brother Earl Campbell came from. They must have had a few good players around time.
Yeah, they get a good shot. That time it's number 40, who did such a good job on the play.
This is something you don't see a lot. The fewest punts in the league were made by Oklahoma. This time it was almost blocked. You got an end over end job. It's out to the 30 yard line. And that ball was almost blocked, but I don't see a flag, so he was not rough. The Cougars get the ball back. Imagine holding Oklahoma on third down and one. The NFC Championship game here on CBS Sports. And all of this always starts with the NFL today with Brent and Irv and everybody back in New York. And, of course, Super Bowl up in the beautiful Silver Dome in Pontiac, Michigan, January the 24th. Wouldn't we like to know the two teams that will end up there? Wouldn't they like to know?
Yeah, it's crazy. With 10 teams left in the playoffs, it's hard to tell who's going to be there. The hot hand on a given Sunday is going to be the difference.
You don't want to go out on a limb and pick anybody, do you?
I'll go out on a limb and say one of the five teams in each conference will be a winner.
Wilson throwing to the outside. Roberson didn't know where he was going. There's a flag drop. I don't know if Roberson threw downfield or if it's going to be on number three.
Arian Walker, I think, Tom, was involved in pass interference on the play. At least it looked like it.
They're going to call it on Barry, and I'm not too sure it was his fault. It looked like Roberson ran into him.
Well, being a great defensive back like you were, there's no way in the world you're going to admit that the defensive back is wrong.
Pass interference. First down.
It was called. Here it is, Hank.
There you see it. Out to the outside. And I'd say that it definitely was a good call. Looked like it at the time.
Inside handoff. As Lionel Wilson really hasn't had a chance to show that he is a good passer. He said he's had to work on that part of his game, and that would be his concentration. Alan Polk carrying straight up the middle. Picked up about 4.5 yards.
John Pruitt on the tackle for Oklahoma.
The worst day that young Wilson had, of course, was against SMU, a very talented team that couldn't go to a bowl this year, but they intercepted young Wilson 5 times. But that's the way you learn. When you're young and you're talented, you got to put it up. Inside move, a good option play outside, but he's jammed there. Number 43 is the one carrying the ball. Robert Durham stood him up in his tracks. Good defensive pursuit by Oklahoma.
Yeah, they have a man assigned to each one of the quarterback, the fullback, and the pitch man, and they really reacted very, very well to the play that time. And for that reason, they didn't succeed in doing a good job.
Has the veer changed much under Yeoman? Is it pretty much the same offense?
Well, they keep changing it a little. They add a few variations to it every year. It's not as basically simple as it used to be. As I mentioned earlier, they have a zone option, they have a trap option, they have a rollout option, an outside veer option.
An option pass turned into a lateral. Looks like it gets close to the first down. Number 45 carried that ball. That's Wiggins. As Yeoman keeps putting in new and fresh backs. It's going to be close. I don't believe it's going to be there, is it? Are they moving those chains? It's going to be fourth. He must have run out of bounds. It's going to be fourth and five. So it's far short of the first down.
Ronnie Stokes will be punting.
Hayworth is back. Here's the punt. It's a pretty good-looking kick. Hitson runs down for the end zone, and it's a leaping spike.
See, he looked like he knocked it out.
By Durham, almost knocked it out. Let's see what they do with it. They're going to bring it out. He laid out full length that time and tried to bat it in there. He'll be out to the 20.
Well, when the ball makes a contact with a fuzzy concrete like it did that time, that's the kind of a bounce you're going to get. It's a lot different on grass.
He had 16 inside the 20-yard line. One of the great young... Harmon is the man that tried to spike that and bring it back. First and 10 for the Oklahoma Sooners as the first quarter is going to be history in one tick of the clock. They'll get off this play and then be going against the wind. Here's a reverse by Shepard. He's going deep for a back coming out, and it's off his hands at the 45-yard line. Buster Rhines. A very tall, talented young player who really hasn't done everything they expect him to do. But he's young. And the first quarter is now history. It's 7-0 Oscar Ham and Freddie Dreyer at the Sunbowl in El Paso, and the Oklahoma Sooners scored on a Shepard touchdown run. The 179th game, by the way, that they have scored touchdowns in. That's the record. Inside Shepard fumbles the lateral back. Big pressure was put on him. And Alvin Ross recovers it for a big loss.
You know, that time, that was the first time they were in that formation. They had a double tight end offense that time. The first time that time they used that, double security on the outside. They tried to run the option to the left side. He goes right down the line and makes a bad pass backwards. Number 34, Alvin Ross, finally recovered. Very wisely, just fell in the football. Had he tried to pick it up, he might have been in trouble.
And now, of course, it'll be third and a lot, third and 25. And this is not a normal Oklahoma offensive situation.
Unbalanced line again this time.
Inside handoff to Stanley Wilson. Dragging a few players out to over the 15-yard line. There's Janine Costa, our young girl at the Sun Bowl Queen. She happens to go to SMU. She's one of the people that believe in Mustang Mania. School where you used to coach.
That's right. I had a great time there with Maddie Bell and Sleepy Bell and people at SMU.
Got a lot of girls like Janine hanging around the campus.
Red McClain, I never noticed that much.
Okay, here's the kick. That's Lionel Fee back to take it on the 40. He's got some running room. He may have a wall. Lionel Fee's being chased and finally dropped at the 41-yard line. As Bill Bechtel, the offensive center, made the tackle. Or was it Steve Owens? Frank Murphy made it. I got it right finally. It's 7-0 in Oklahoma lead.
First and 10 for Houston.
Country, it's a great classic. Inside handoff. Didn't fool anybody that time. Alan Pope carried three up the middle, picked up maybe 3.5-4 yards.
And Tom, talking about the nice people here, you ought to feel mighty proud about the nice headpiece you got for luncheon the other day. They feel very strongly about you and the great job that you have done here through the years.
Those are real Indian feathers they had on. Or not Indian feathers, but I mean real bird feathers on that headdress. But I couldn't wear it for the opening up on the roof. I might have sailed away and ended up in Mexico.
I thought you looked pretty cute in it, though.
Yeah, I know. You love that. Second down and call it 9. Only a 2-yard pickup was anything. Here's inside move by Lionel Wilson, and he is being swarmed under. Looks like the Sooners are getting their defense going. Okay, Fred Dreyer on the sidelines.
Well, guys, it's 7-0 Oklahoma. People on the sideline here at Oklahoma, the coaches and the players, are feeling pretty confident about the game. They're getting the things done offensively and defensively that they wanted to do before the game started. So everything is going great except for a couple of bad calls. Of course, that's the way football is, isn't it, Tom?
It's always been that way for me, Freddie. You're absolutely right. Dreyer on the sidelines. And the crowd's still under control. That's hard to believe. Lionel Wilson now. Oh, good fake. He's got time to throw whatever he wants to do with it. Finds number 32. Alan Pope makes a good catch out to the 45-yard line. and a first down. I don't see any flags down.
No, and Wilson really did a good job of reading the defense that time. He was trying to get the ball outside to the split end, but they double covered, meaning they had two people on the outside receivers. The only place he could really throw the ball was inside. He did it, and Polk makes a nice catch, number 32.
That may get Lionel Wilson started now that he's beginning to move the football and find his receivers. That was a good catch by Polk, the senior. Inside handoff. Wow, he is met head on at the 44-yard line. That was Wiggins carrying the ball.
John Blake really made good contact that time. Really stuck his head in there. Right on the numbers, used the shoulder pads well. Number 90, John Blake, 6'2", 255, the junior.
And the defensive line coach is Lucius Selman, who, of the Selman brothers, of course, nobody is better, I guess, than Leroy in the National Football League, but that Selman name means a lot at Oklahoma, and he does a great job coaching. Second down and nine.
And a double coverage again on the outside. They've got to try to get the ball inside.
Boy's getting a lot of time to throw right now. Good-looking throw. As Feed takes it in traffic. Another first down for Houston and a good throw by Lionel Wilson. That one was on the money.
Yes, and that was a good adjustment that time. Feed went to the middle area. That was where the big cavity was. He found him, drilled it right on the numbers. Good-looking play. Feed makes the necessary yardage for the first down. Good faking inside. A lot of time to throw the ball. Does a little tap dance back there, but finally gets it inside. And a big first down for the Houston team.
Well, I like Lionel Wilson as a football player. He's going to get nothing but better. And Fee is already there, of course. I think we'll be watching him here on CBS and the NFL later on. Down, Polk gets down to the 25-yard line, diving to get it.
You know, people, as you watch two teams play, as much as they reverse pivot, they don't come right out and hand the ball to the back. They reverse pivot and give him the football, and the timing and the execution play of the pivot is really good, very sensational.
This might be young Polk's last game for Houston. He's a senior. He said he had the bad knee injury a couple of seasons ago, but he's having some kind of a good afternoon so far. Second down, five. On the run, Wilson to Ford. Big tight end who's a good pass receiver as Bill Yeoman gets ready to put another back in there with another play. A wide open offense.
Yeah, they're pumping the ball up pretty much here this afternoon. And that time, again, they had one-on-one on the outside. Wisely rolled to that side and got the advantage that they were seeking. And got the ball to their tight end, Mike Ford.
Yeoman, of course, starred, was an All-American at Army, and then went on the staff with Red Blake and a fellow named Vince Lombardi happened to be on that staff. Pretty good place to start.
Pretty good company, and he started at Michigan State. He was at Michigan State in 1954 when I was at Purdue, and so we became good friends at that particular stage of our respective careers.
And good careers they have been. Polk looks like he picked up the first down by a few inches. It was third and less than a yard. He didn't get much. They're going to call for a timeout and get the measurement. The official says that one's on me, fellas.
Timeout for a measurement.
9:43 left before halftime. On one of the most beautiful days you'll ever see in the southwestern part of Texas, in this country. 35,000 people here, and they're making the stadium big enough to hold 52 in another year or so for the Sun Bowl. It's not. It's going to be close time. You got to go for it, don't you, in a bowl game?
Oh, I would think so. In less than a yard, you have to go for it. And, of course, that's the kind of a situation they like. The wishbone teams, the beard teams, they like to be in a third and short situation as often as they possibly can, like everybody else. In pro football, you know how many times you come up with a third and three time?
Yep.
About three times a game, that's all.
You got to get them in, don't you?
Yes, sir. But in the college game, they stay out of the third and long situation. They want to be, they fight for the third and three or third and short. They have it here in this situation on fourth down.
You got a great running back as the quarterback. And it's less than a yard, and it's fourth down. Lionel Wilson is going to try to keep it himself and doesn't make it. As Dwight Drain, the sophomore, the 191-pounder, came up and put a solid tackle on, and Oklahoma's going to take over. What a defensive play.
There again is another great illustration of having man-for-man responsibility. The option, he takes it out, and watch who comes into the picture. Look at the great shot by number 33, Dwight Drain, 6'1", 191, sophomore. Boy, what a beautiful play.
And Steve Whaley, the linebacker or the defensive end, made a good play, too. Oklahoma holds, and they also hold the lead. All right, let's go down to Fred Dreyer to the sidelines. Freddie, where are you now?
Well, I'm on the Sooner sideline. That last defensive series is just a sample of the great line of tradition of defense they've had. Notice Johnny Blake, number 90, the great nose tackle for the Sooners. He's the only guy on the whole field of the 22 people with a shirt tail hanging out. That's a great sign of a great defensive lineman.
Shades of Rich Glover a few years ago for Oklahoma. He had the same problem, but played well. That was Stanley Wilson carrying the ball, picking up 4 or 5 yards. You know, Hank, it's very hard to keep. There's our young friend right there. There's Blake. Coach, would you let him run around with a shirt tail hanging out, or would you care if he played well?
I think if he played well, it wouldn't bother you too much. No, really, we made him keep his shirt tail. We put a thumbtack in the bottom of the shirt and made him tack it in and keep it in.
You used to use thumbtacks on your hands, too. You did everything. Here's the handoff to Buster Rhymes. He's the sophomore, 215 pounds, 6'3". He's got a high average per carry, but they're expecting him to be one of the great outside runners maybe in their history, and that's some history.
Yeah, they really like him very, very much and have great expectations. But I think, when talking to Barry the other day, he indicated that probably in pro football, Rhymes would probably be an outside receiver if he was lucky. Yeah, get away from everybody.
Third down. Call it 5 yards. Inside handoff. Stanley Wilson. Who else?
Wilson up the middle.
Then a lot of problems then. A very good secondary for the Cougars. It's going to bring up a fourth down in a punting situation as the pom-poms are flying. There's Freddie Dreyer's friend, the Amigo man.
Looks like he's gained a little weight.
Mike Keeley, a two-way kicker. How many of those are there around? Punter and the field goal man.
Lonel
Fee is back to take it. A very dangerous return person. Ooh, takes a step toward the line and kicks a sort of an in-zone header type kick. Taken by Vonner. Houston will put the ball in play about the 37-yard line.
You know what happened that time? The deep back almost bumped right into him, backed into him, and to avoid doing that, he went to the right a little bit and got the ball off. He'd have had a size 8 right in the back of his pants.
The pass caught by Fee. That would be the seventh completion for young Wilson.
Boy, what a nice-looking play that was. He faked inside a play action, delivered the ball to the left side to Fee, who made the catch. The ball was thrown right at the numbers where it has to be thrown in that kind of a situation. That kind of a pass, you want to make sure you throw it down below the neck, not above, because it could be a tipping drill if it's thrown high.
Good point. I like Lonel Fee. He does catch it with people hanging on and around him. Here's the inside drive play. Cuts back inside. Wilson gets right into the middle of the Sun Bowl symbol and into Oklahoma territory. Bobby Slater made that tackle.
Tackle on the play by Bob Slater.
We understand Shipp is not playing at linebacker. He's got a virus, a flu struck him. The fine young sophomore linebacker, the leading tackler in Big 8 history this year, is being replaced by Jerry Sanders, the junior, the 218-pounder. We hope Shipp feels better. Sanders is playing well. Here's the rollout by Wilson. Got some room. Boy, there was no doubt he was just going to keep it that time. Gets almost to the 40-yard line. Bobby Slater got him the nose man.
And Danny Wilson did a good job of containing the play and taking a good angle to the outside and finally making the tackle. Never think about Houston without thinking about our old pal Lloyd C. Wells, who did such a great job of scouting for us. He's from Houston. Kansas City. Yeah, did a great job for us. Lloyd Wells, out of sight.
Bill Yeoman, 20 years as the coach. Great tradition. He's building a very, very fast time. The University of Houston hasn't been athlete sports for as many years as most schools. That's Wiggins getting the carry straight up the middle. It won't be enough, obviously, for a first down. Freddie Dreyer on the sidelines. Come in, Fred.
Well, that guy up there is not Lloyd C. Wells, Hank.
I thought that was you up there.
That, you're not going to believe this, but that's Marty Robbins. And he got here on these two guys right here. Boomer and Sooner. Hi, guys. Yeah, no carrots. They came all the way here from Oklahoma on the freeway without a radiator. Can you believe it?
Make sure you don't feed those animals any of that rice.
It's unbelievable.
Alan Polk inside. The senior picking up good yardage and the first down.
Stop was made.
Good looking hold open up on the left side of the offensive line. Albert Watts had to make the tackle in the secondary.
Yeah, Ranson and Marshall did a good job of knocking them off the line of scrimmage that time. And here comes number 90. for Oklahoma, John Blake with a shirt hanging out.
Remember, the Cougars got down here the series before and missed on fourth and a foot. Let's see what'll happen this time. Wilson's being stopped at the 25-yard line. John Truitt, the sophomore sensation, making that tackle. Boy, there's some player.
Yeah, he's 6'3", 201, a sophomore, but he's very quick, very active, and has a good combination of quickness and speed, which is what you have to have.
He and the great runner Stanley Wilson both come from Carson, California. Stanley came one year and got his friend to come the next year. That's good recruiting, too.
That's usually the best kind of recruiting you can have.
Bring your best friend if he's really good.
That's right.
All right, second down and 9. The ball's on the 25. Got a lot of time to pass. Tyler Wilson with all the time in the world. Maybe nobody open. Good throw to the sidelines. Almost at the 15-yard line. Alan Polk. Boy, that was some rifle. That was a good throw.
And the big thing was he had all the time in the world to throw the ball. They danced around. They were very concerned about trying to keep him in the pocket so he wouldn't jump out of the pocket and run. And for that reason, he had all the time in the world to play action fake. He's back into the pocket. The play's going to throw. Number 80 jumps up Ryan. So he moves to his right. Finally delivers the ball right on the money outside. And they make the reception, third and short.
And it's... very short. Third inside. Goes Wiggins. Head down, taking the handoff. He'll move the sticks. That's what the immediate timeout was. There's Barry Switzer wondering about his young defense. Can they stop this team? Two national titles. In fact, his team, the second year he was down at Oklahoma, went 11-0. That was one of the great college teams, I guess, that's ever been put together.
You know, it's hard to win as many games as Barry has won if you just have count the inter-squad games. It's unbelievable, isn't it?
86% of them, the winningest percentage in football. Here's the reverse option play. Alan Polk takes
run out of bounds.
Wilson's handoff and gets wrapped around the neck and out of bounds.
Jackie Ship.
How about this tackle right here, Hank?
Yeah, number 49 really does a good job of making the play. Jackie Ship, the weak linebacker.
179 during the year.
Second and 8 on the 13.
A smile on his face right now. Probably more when he makes good contact. Linebackers are like that.
You got a lot of room on the right side of the field. You think maybe they'll do a little business over here, Thomas.
All right, Roberson is out that way. The young man with all the speed. Second down and 8 on the 13. Back to the weak side is where Wilson's going. He logs this one out of the end zone. There is a flag down, though, as the receiver was forced out. That would have been... would have been Wiggins that was trying to get up for it. And I believe Watts is the one that gave him the help.
Unusual that time, Tom. You know, went right back where all the folks were that time. And in spite of it, got away with murder with pass interference calling the play.
Now, that's Fee over there. That's the good outside receiver on that side. Here's the bump and...
defensive interference in the end zone. It's first down, 1 yard line.
The ball was airborne. Good call on the part of the official.
First and goal. We have a 7-0 Oklahoma lead that looks like it might evaporate before halftime. 3:41 left. The wind is the Cougars back. Inside drive. Wilson takes it himself and scores. Lionel Wilson scores. And if the extra point is good, if it's a kick, we will have that tie game. No doubt then what he wanted to do. Got the fake across. From Jones High in Houston, Texas. Yes, he's a blue chipper, folks. And he's got 2 more years.
He fakes to the fullback and then follows the fullback right into the hole. Good-looking play. Wilson scoring from a yard out.
Clint Dennett barefooted for his field goals and extra points. Greg Harmon is holding there, number 44. The wide bars, college football, it's good. Boy, it's really good. A sailor with 3:39 left before halftime here in beautiful El Paso, Texas. It's a 7-7 tie, and nobody's going home for this kickoff. Ball is out of the end zone. It goes over the uprights, but that will not count, folks. Let's go down right now to Freddie Dreyer, who has a favorite friend of mine, too.
I've got an interesting little guest for me. Hank, remember Elmo Wright, the great receiver for your Kansas City Chiefs?
Yeah, the nice jig he used to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Remember the guy that played behind him at the University of Houston? You don't, do you?
Yes.
What was his name?
Well, you tell me. I'm checking
about,
on you.
How about Larry Gatlin?
That's right.
Here he is. Larry, how are you?
I'm fine. How you, Britt? Good old coach.
Hi, Larry. How are you?
I'm fine. How y'all doing?
How you doing, Larry?
I'm doing fine. Hello, Brooke.
Where's all the gold in California these days?
Some of it's in the bank account in Nashville, thank God. We'll take all we can get.
The great country and western man, Larry Gatlin of the Gatlin Brothers. That's Alvin Ross on the outside toss play from Shepard, picking up big yardage and a first down for Oklahoma. Donnie Love made the tackle.
There we set, fakes the inside belly, faking to the fullback, tossing to the outside to number 34. Breaks to the outside, Alvin Ross in good shape, picks up a nice gain in the play.
Some block by Buster Rhymes, number 4, the halfback.
Still on balance line to the right.
We're going to take a look at that. Here's the drive series hit by Shepard. Keeps it herself behind that extra blocker. All the way to the 46. Unbalanced line. Somebody will do that in Pro Bowl one of these Sundays, and that 34 is going to scratch its head and go back in the huddle.
Well, remember Washington Redskins with Joe Koharik did that one for the whole one season and did a good job with it.
The trouble was they just couldn't score any points.
Line weren't too small. They had these linemen, they'd have been all right.
The offensive line for Oklahoma does average 265 pounds, and Byford, the big offensive right tackle, as we told you, is about 270-something, and Crouch at left guard is at least 275. It is mammoth. Here's Shepard back, getting rushed, gets it off, a gimmicky pass, intercepted, almost that is intercepted at the 20-yard line. That's Easton, Easy Easton, they call him, racing to the 40. A 26th interception for the Cougars in a season when the young backs have really played some defense. Bechtold finally made the stop, the center. Easy Easton, they call him, from Houston, stayed right home to play his football.
Yes, and he caught it twice, like we said earlier in the game, like you said, Tom. Fakes inside, throws the ball on top. Easton is there. He's the only one that's really open on the play. It hits a shoulder pad, bounces up into the air, finally comes down with it. Play action fake inside. Shepard throwing off the back foot. And here Houston has possession.
The sixth interception for Easton. A long pass by Lionel Wilson, and it's just over Fee's hands. And I mean, he was motoring. Pretty well covered, though, at the corner spot by Hayworth. Boy, that was some long throw. What an arm.
Yeah, you got to measure that one. That was a long one.
It's a good foot race here.
Yeah, number 33, Drain, that time, really did a good job of staying with Fee man for man. It was man for man coverage, and that's what you get most of the time when you play against the Veer, and that's why I think Houston is trying to do as much throwing as they're doing here this afternoon to take advantage of that one-for-one coverage.
And the wind, too, that is gusty here in the Southwest, but it is beautiful. The sky is cobalt blue. That's what they call it. Here's the inside fake and the toss back. That's Wiggins chasing it down. Lionel Wilson sort of hung him out to dry that time. Well, that'd be awful to get that lateral thrown to you in the wrong position. You're trying to look for people to run past and still get control of the ball.
And that ball has to be for the perfect exchange, Tom. It has to be delivered out in front of the numbers, about a yard out in front, so that you don't have to break stride. You make the catch and get up the field. As soon as you deviate from that kind of a route, then you're in trouble, and that's what happened on the play.
Only 5 Cougars are from out of the state of Texas. They stay right home. Like that fellow there, I know he's not from Manhattan. Back to throw again. Lionel Wilson. Gave some time. He's trying to screen back to the far side to Alan Polk. Read pretty well by the Oklahoma defense out to about the 36-yard line.
And the left tackle, Ranson, made a good block on the outside man that time and provided him with the little running room that he had. Had he not made the block, he'd have been in trouble.
Oklahoma defense, it's getting more age and experience. Boy, next year they're going to be tough. The people waiting to play are tough. Watts is back to take the punt. Hayworth is back. Bouncing over his head, they'll try to go in the end zone. It's a race, and it will. It'll come out to the 20-yard line, and Oklahoma will have a minute and 37 seconds to break the tie. What about the wishbone if you're trying to do it under a two-minute drill? What happens then?
Well, you know, I think everybody knows, and I think Oklahoma feels that any time they have to play catch-up football and have to get back into the game quickly, you know, they rely so much on the run that it's very difficult for them to play that kind of a game. With the game 7-7, they're still in good shape.
At halftime today, Brent Musburger back in New York with a report from Philadelphia on tomorrow's NFC wild card playoff game between the Eagles and the Giants. Plus, a feature of the one and only, the Bear, Bear Bryant, the Alabama coach. All that at halftime today, right here from the Sun Bowl to New York. Run off the left side. Looks like they're content now to go in with a 7-7 tie, perhaps.
Yeah, I think they're going to pump some sand in the ball and just not use it for a passing a weapon. That time they were in a double tight end offense. Second time they've been in that formation. And he kept the ball that time, made a pretty good game.
Darrell Shepard from down in Odessa. Boy, that's the oil country. And everybody comes out of there has got muscles everywhere.
And they can all say, you bet.
You bet. He's quite a young player. Inside handoff.
Go Stanley Wilson.
Oh, out to the 35-yard line. What looks like a 2 or 3 yard gainer, and Wilson really puts it.
Throw the ball.
He's down on the ground. Looks like he is shaken up. That is a pretty good AstroTurf field, though. It is has a little bounce down there, but he got drilled at the 35.
Well, he's got great vision, does a good job of running to the open area, and does so without any hesitation at all. Makes he's very decisive. And that's what a great back has to do. He has to be able to make a decision, right or wrong, and get up the field and do a job.
He's got a little bit of lateral movement that I like for a fullback. He made a pretty good move.
Yes, he did. And Reggie Vonner came in late to make the tackle, number 6.
In only 9 games, Stanley Wilson put up those numbers, and he has a senior year waiting for him in Oklahoma. Watch the All-American, Terry Crouch, number 75.
And when he gets a little bit more size and maturity, he's going to be a very good tackle.
Wilson has 84 yards rushing, and we're waiting to see how he comes out of it. Don't forget, following the Sun Bowl today, stay with CBS Sports for 2 of the top-ranked teams in NCAA basketball. Denny Crum's University of Louisville Cardinals takes on Ray Myers and the DePaul Blue Demons. The teams are loaded. It should be a great shootout. Billy Packer and Gary Bender at courtside here on CBS NCAA. Wilson is being helped off. A big hand, but he is... You can't tell the injuries from up here. 87 yards on 14 carries. And we hope he's all right because this young man's career is just beginning. The ball is on the 35. It's a first and 10 with 15 seconds left and counting. Inside by Shepard Keats. He's got a lot of room outside. He's going to stay with it himself for the 44 before he's upended. Bobby Love making the tackle. Seems like there have been a Love playing at the University of Houston forever. There's one playing with the Cardinals now, Randy. A couple of brothers played here earlier.
And they're all good players. Which is very obvious, or else they wouldn't be here in this bowl game.
Remember, Miami beat this team early in the year with 4 field goals. That was when the young Lionel Wilson took over as quarterback and Miller went down with the shoulder separation.
I'm talking about Miami, what a great job Howard did at the University of Miami with that team.
Coach of the year, huh?
Yeah, terrific. Howard Schnellenberger. Terrific.
Good programs around the country, and there's nothing more fun for people that do the professional game to be able to go back to college once in a while. Don't forget tomorrow. Starts with the NFL today at 3 o'clock. It's the Giants. We don't call them New York anymore, just the Giants, but they're from Gotham City against the Philadelphia Eagles. Vermeil and the work ethic Eagles are back into the tracks after a 38-0 shutout. You think the Giants can beat them again, Hank?
Listen, anything can happen. The way things have been in the National Football League this year, the only thing predictable about the league has really been this unpredictability. Never know what's going to happen.
That's the only predictable thing, the unpredictability.
Yeah.
Right? Wilson, by the way, was holding his left side on the sidelines. It might be the ribs. Hopefully nothing real serious. The ball trying to be thrown by Shepard, and I don't know if the arm came forward or if they're going to call it a fumble. Terry Monroe making the big, big rush.
Yeah, I think it came forward that time. I think they're going to call it a incompleted forward pass.
Was the ball in his hand when it came forward? The officials from the Southeastern Conference.
Looked like it might have had some peanut butter on it the way it slipped out of there that time.
A bar of soap, incomplete pass. 31 seconds left. Third down and a short one. Reverse handoff option. Shepard, a good runner, gets to midfield, and then he's stopped by Brady Turner.
Boy, they do a good job with that option play. They put a lot of pressure on it. It didn't look like much, but all you do is move the chains, and that's what they're That's what they want to do with the option style of offense.
The Sun Bowl since 1936. The Rose Bowl and the Orange and the Sugar all started at that same time. And in 1936, the sun started shining. Here it is on first down. Shepard trying to sneak out. Gets the ball spiked by a big defensive lineman and caught and now run out of bounds. Alvin Ross ended up with it. But who batted it? I believe it was Terry Monroe, that big right tackle. 6 foot 5 inch right defensive tackle. Let's see.
Yeah, that time the quarterback did not get very deep in the pocket. He normally doesn't get very deep, and for that reason, any penetration at all, you're going to get that kind of a play defensively.
Might be one of the best pass plays that Switzer's had at Oklahoma this year. They don't throw it a lot. Good practice for a team that is the leading rushing team, I guess, almost in the history of college football. They won the rushing title for what, the eighth time this year to win the national rushing title, which is a lot. There's Stanley Wilson coming off, the junior. So he looks like he's all right.
Yeah, they come off the airplane running the ball, and they do it all through the game, do a great job of it.
I tell you, both these teams did a lot of dancing here in the last few days, too, you know. Oklahoma didn't work out for 8 days before coming down here because they had the midterm exams back at the university. So they did a lot of hard work here, but they also got to taste the hospitality here in El Paso. Shepard being rushed and gets away at the 30. Shepard now fumbling and not getting away at the 33-yard line. Nate Trust was the one that forced him out of bounds. And both teams are going in to get the tape all set.
But that's what they've been doing in the early stage of the game.
There he is, the blue chipper out of Odessa. Larry Gatlin went to his high school, we found out. Odessa cranks them out. They clone good players. Here's a first and 10 now, right on the 30-yard line. Inside drive, the handoff to Freddie Sims. Freshman gets out over the 40 to the 42 in a hurry.
A good surge that time by the offensive line of the Oklahoma Sooners. He gets a good cavity, a good seam, and pops right through there for a nice gain. Talking about Fred Sims, number 23, the young freshman, 5'10", 202.
Not a bad dimension to have for a running back these days. If you're too tall, you can end up running into big arms and what have you at that height. Sometimes better be a little stocky.
And make sure you're fast. If you're short, you better be fast.
Here's the bone. It's Sims again. Out to midfield. Very quick sliding off that block on the nose guard. There are the numbers. A 4.2 average. Five touchdowns. Lacroix, the defensive back, came up to make the tackle, the junior. And Butch had seven interceptions this year. He was like third in the nation on INTs.
You know, Tom, they use a double tight end offense again the last two times. They're in it again this time, getting more firepower, making people play on the line of scrimmage and trying to take advantage of the seams they have and the gaps on defense.
The straight wishbone now. No more fooling around with the flankers. That's Alvin Ross, the right halfback, taking it. Again, you think the real secret to controlling the bone is to get that pullback and make sure he doesn't have it, huh?
Well, you gotta make sure you stop him first because they keep sticking him inside. If you're not careful, they lull you to sleep and give it to him, and he's gone for a big gain up the middle.
I remember when Parsegian took Notre Dame in to play Texas when Wooster and that team was there for Darrell Royal, and that's how they beat Texas was, as you showed, with a mirror defense where they lined up and just mirrored the bone on defense and did a pretty good job. Parsegian, a good coach, of course.
Yeah, one of the greatest.
Here's the outside move. Shepard gets a good tackle put on him at the 47-yard line, and it stops right there. Grady Turner, a sure tackle.
See, that time his responsibility, Grady Turner, his responsibility was to tackle the quarterback, and one of the outside people had the pitch man. They did a good job of making the play. Grady Turner, 6 foot, 216, a senior. Very fine, strong linebacker.
Got a great number, too, at 40.
Yeah, that's super. I wonder who wore that number.
Not many people were brave enough to try that. It's second down. Second down, 11. The ball's on the 48 of Houston. Inside drive. That's Sims. Oh, he slides off that first block very quickly. Grady Turner making another tackle. Here you are, Coach. Here's your replay.
Yeah, there we go. He's got good, you know what, he's got very good lean, very good balance, talking about Fred Sims, 5'10", 202, number 23. He was playing for the injured Stanley Wilson.
Third down and seven. Shepard is, they've taken the opening kickoff, and the young quarterback is moving. Now, oh, he doesn't get there. Number 89 really socks it. That's Eugene Lockhart, the big sophomore. Yeah, it looks to me like the Cougars are really hitting, but right now, Oklahoma still has the football. What do you look for on this third and something? You look for the pass, finally?
I would surely think they would, no, they're going to, it's fourth down, they're going to punt the ball.
Oh, it is fourth.
Yeah, fourth and ten.
And the breeze right in the kicker's face. He, of course, will be the receiver and the seldom-used punter, Keeley. He just doesn't punt a lot. In fact, he punts the fewest times in the nation. Oh, he drills this one. Gets the win and all. He just kicks it right out. Well, the Cougars get the football for the first time in the second half. From the 20-yard line, a 7-7 tie. Oklahoma and Houston. Instead, even they got their eyes open today. Here's the handoff to Durham on the left side. Picking up good yardage for about 7 yards.
That's that trap option again, Tom. Steve Williams, a right guard, is pulling to his left. They fake to him and then toss the ball to the outside. Boy, good-looking play. But the pass and the run, everything looks exactly the same, so it puts a lot of pressure on the defense.
Breaking out. Lionel Wilson, the quarterback, one of the great athletes in the country. Roberson is flanked to the right. Inside, Alan Pope diving forward. Enough for the first, but signal looks. At least that's what the Houston bench thinks. Fellow walked all the way in from Houston. Somebody said that the state of Texas is so big that we're closer to San Diego, California than we are to Houston, Texas. Did you know that?
That's true. No, I didn't know it until they told us about it late yesterday. It took about an hour and 20 minutes to fly from San Diego. It takes about 1:50 to fly to Houston.
Well, you got all those time schedules, don't you? Des Marshall limping off the field, a big lineman. Here's the inside fake and keep by Wilson. Truett making the tackle. Oklahoma trying to stop a real good offense.
Well, that's
here with a lot of different ways to move the football.
Yeah, and again, I mentioned it early, but Bill Yeoman says they have a veer option, a zone option, a trap option, and of course they got that rollout series, well, that's an option. But they put a lot of pressure on it, and then, of course anybody in football knows that the toughest play is some kind of an option, pass or run.
240-pound sophomore, that's Marshall over there, Scott Marshall. They'll work him and get him back in there if they can. Here's the pass play. It's complete to Fee. In traffic again. And enough for another first down for Houston.
They can do that a lot more than they've done it, very honestly, Tom. They're playing it too deep with the safeties playing the deep half of the field. For that reason, the middle area is open, and they ought to be able to take better advantage of it than they have, really. They dropped a couple of passes in the air, but that time they connected in good shape.
I keep worrying about that Lionel Wilson running with the follow. He has an 81-yard touchdown run this year, and you've got to be a fast athlete to do that from the quarterback. Here's the handoff inside to Alan Polk, again getting yardage.
But there was a trap again. So they keep you honest. They stick it in there with the trap. The right guard pulls, Steve Williams, number 76, but they throw the anchovy in there for it to take a little swallow to take a bait, and then they go right outside. They go right outside with the option.
Brian Wilkinson, the 254-pound senior, is in for Marshall. And they moved right over his position that time for a good gain. It's going to be called second and five. Just into Oklahoma territory. Reverse handoff option out to the weak side. This is the runner. Wilson as the quarterback inside the 40.
See, there again, that time they faked the trap. And then he kept it, ran the option, made a nice gain on the play. Beautiful looking play by the quarterback, number 12, Lionel Wilson.
Marshall's back in, and Drain made that last tackle. A very steady drive this time by the Cougars from the 20, and they're inside the 40-yard line. A 7-7 tie. And in all honesty, Houston had a chance to get some points in that first quarter and didn't. But that's good defense, too.
Oh, yeah, they have to give Oklahoma a lot of credit. They've done a much better job defensively than they expected, the way they talked about their defense.
First down give to Durham. Inside the 35.
Robert Durham carries for Houston.
They have a lot of confidence in the running backs. They keep changing the running backs, talking about Houston. They're sending in the plays with the running backs.
And on the 34.
Now, Dallas Wiggins comes back in with another play from the sideline, number 45.
Second down and five, a play from Barry Switzer. Of course, Galen Hall is the offensive coordinator, my old buddy from Penn State. Let's see what they're going to do on defense. Here's their good defensive play by Oklahoma. I believe they have a fumble recovered.
Strong safety blitz that time. Gary Lowell that time, number 25, blitzing on the play.
And Stanberry, I believe his running mate, may have come up with the football, the other safety. The pressure put on by the Oklahoma defense. They've done a lot of that this year, though, tackling people for losses.
Here he comes. There's 19. 19. Keith Stanberry is the one who got the ball, got tipped, and created the fumble opportunity.
And got the ball, too. Blake was there, too. There he is from Mount Pleasant, Texas. A big turnover, and this time the Sooners get it. It's a 7-7 tie, and Oklahoma has the football back. Back at the Sun Bowl, Tom Brookshire with Hank Stram. Freddie Dreyer is loose behind the Oklahoma bench. We'll get a little update on Stanley Wilson's condition here in a few minutes. Sims is in there for him, and that's a full bone. That's the wishbone. First and 10, the ball's on the 45. Inside handoff to Sims, the freshman. Okay, Fred.
Hello.
Hello there, Fred.
Yeah. Now, Stanley Steamer Wilson will not be back in the game. He's got broken ribs, so he'll be gone for the remainder of the day. They've got number 23, Freddie Sims, in there. Now, they will not deviate from their game plan at all offensively. They like him very much. He's a tough blocker and a tough kid, so they're going to go on just like the Steamer was in there.
Stanley Steamer Wilson, huh? It's a good handle to put on him there, Freddie. Freddie Dreyer. New in the television business, and it's going to be a lot of fun, Fred. You're doing a good job down there. Here's the inside drive play. That's Sims again. Boy, he is quick. Sims is still on his feet at the 30, cutting back. Sims is dragged down on the 14-yard line from behind. He got there in a hurry. It was Lockhart who had a tackling from behind. He's got to have 4-4 speed.
And listen, their 4-4 blockers up front, too. Byford, that time, the right tackle. They do a super job of getting off the line of scrimmage. The right guard, Williams, the center, Bechtol, all of whom did a good job of making something happen up front.
Lockhart over the top, making that tackle. Oklahoma very suddenly using their freshman fullback. Wilson is out, and they've moved it. Shepard is the quarterback. And he's the Houdini, too. It's first down. Side. Sims, there's a flag down. Did somebody move early that time?
I didn't notice it that time. Really didn't. They had their double tight end offense in the game again to get more firepower.
Been very few penalties called.
Very well played game from that standpoint.
Tough but clean.
Hard hitting.
Delay a game. Offense.
Barry not too happy with that one. 25 seconds. To get the playoff college ball. And he knows he's got a young team. The only year that he hasn't won or tied for the Big 8 title in 9 seasons was this season. He wants to end that. First down and 15 with that 5-yard penalty. A lot of shifting going on that defensive side. Here's the toss. Back to Buster Rhymes, the 6'3", 215-pounder. Good defensive play that looked like Harmon.
Grady Turner also gets through there in good shape and made the play.
Buster Rhymes a little bit scary too, isn't he? He looks like he can just motor somewhat.
Well, he's high split. He is a high split guy and can really fly to the outside.
Somebody fired on a quarterback and really did a job on Shepard. Good thing he got the handoff made. Grady Turner firing in there. All right, big play, second down and 15. Option left side by Shepard. Toss back to Alvin Ross. Alvin Ross has running room and gets to the 10-yard line. And it's nose-to-nose there with Donnie Love.
Alvin Ross that time looked like he was going to get captured in the backfield, but he's got terrific speed, got around the outside. Here's Shepard taking the ball to the fullback. Number 35 comes across there in good shape. Donnie Love pitches the ball to 34. Alvin Ross, and he gets around the corner in good shape. Got the ball in the wrong arm, but he's doing a good job of running. He's pretty good for distance.
Very good from Aurora, Illinois, right outside of Chicago. 195-pounder picks up it good. It's third down at 6. This is the biggest play of the game so far. You're talking about points. Shepard. Now the flags are down. Shepard still carried it. Everybody stopping because they see the flags, but Shepard doesn't. Now we'll get the call by the officials. Illegal motion against Oklahoma.
You know, that's a bad thing to do, though, from a defensive standpoint. You better not officiate the game. You just better play it. Let the officials call the plays, because sometimes you never know how they're going to call it. Could have been an easy touchdown.
Let the coaches do the officiating, too. You know that.
Well, that's all right. Sure, the officials and the coaches can officiate.
Somebody moved illegally, and it's going to bring up third and long. A couple of mistakes. Didn't get the play off in time. Now a little movement. Now third down 11. 7-7 tie. And most people think that if Oklahoma maybe had a fumble against SC and lost that cup game, they might have gone to the Heights this year. Shepard wants a timeout. Either the wrong alignment or the wrong play call.
It looked like at the last minute, Jeff Williams went over to the right side. Whether that was a problem or not, you don't know. But it looked like the formation was intact. They wound up with a double tight end offense. It looked like that was all right.
Burt Reynolds once was a running back for Florida State in a losing cause here. And we've got a third down 11 call on the 15. Oklahoma driving. Inside, Shepard keeps it. He's going to get to the 15 and get a lot of...
Looked like
wood laid on it. Trust made the first contact.
Looked like had he given a ball to the fullback, he'd have popped through there for a big gain. He elected to keep it himself that time. And, of course, that's the judgment of the quarterback. He has to give it to the fullback or keep it himself. It looked like the fullback popped through there in pretty good shape. Had he given him the ball, he might have made a nice gain on the play.
And, of course, this will bring in young Keeley, who does the punting and the kicking. And it's Septian, Raphael Septian of the Dallas Cowboys, is his idol. The shoe is off. The foot is up. It's good. Looks like Septian's been working with the young man from Dallas. Keeley drives it through, and the Sooners go back on top by three. They broke great defense. The Eagles with the same. Looks like it should be some kind of a war.
Yeah, it should be, and especially so since Philadelphia lost to the Giants the last time they played. It'll be a good contest, no question about that.
And, of course, the NFL today will be in Philadelphia right at the site, so that'll all be right there from the city of brotherly love. Here's Alan Polk on the outside taking the pitch from Wilson. Wilson got dropped, by the way, as the Sooners came through and made sure that the option was carried out.
And Lonel Fee that time, 5'10 and a half, 167, really made a beautiful block on the outside man, and that's why he was able to make 9 yards on the play, second and short.
Fee, by the way, is one of the top four or five or six outside receivers that the professional people are thinking about. And that blocking is very necessary. Roberson, the young sophomore, is to the bottom of the screen. Here's the inside handoff to Alan Polk, the busy senior.
Now that middle continues to be wide open. They get a little better field position. I'm sure they're going to try to explore the possibility of getting the ball inside, but the safeties are very deep and playing outside, and the middle is wide open.
Well, they're probably protecting against the offensive right tackle, Pfeiffer, too, the big fellow that's such a good blocker. Maybe they're running inside thinking that Oklahoma's adjusting because of him, you think? They play a little wide in there?
Yeah, I think they are sometimes. They're worried about the trap. They got to, that time they faked the trap again and ran the trap option.
Good defensive play on Durham, though. Boy, that time, they must have had five people in those big red shirts waiting. Gary Lowell made the first stop.
They continue to run to the short side of the field, and they surely must have a specific reason for doing it. Looked like they got a lot more room on the outside to the strong side of the field, and that they would maybe take better advantage of it than they have.
On second down and 10, we are anticipating the pass, I suppose. I wonder if Oklahoma.
Look at that middle.
Go deep.
Lionel Wilson, almost fumbled the snap, rolling on the run, dumps it out to his tight end, Mark Ford, who is drilled at the 37-yard line and hard. That was Steve Whaley making the stop.
See, the double cover the outside people, meaning they have two people in that area. They may let him catch the ball and come up quickly to make the tackle, and so it's like, you know, throwing spitballs at a battleship. You're going to make a few yards, but not many.
Spitballs at the battleship. He'll bring up third down and 7. Good defensive play that time.
Boy, wasn't it?
Ford just made the one catch and stopped. Number one. Man in red. Everybody has red on either Houston's or Oklahoma's. The outside blitzing this time. Lionel dumps it out. He is wide open. This is Durham. at the 30 being chased. Durham is knocked out of bounds and the ball fumbles out of the end zone, but there was no control. Elbert Watts made the tackle. Let's see if they're going to give Oklahoma the football and a touchback.
I think they're going to, let's see, I don't know what they're going to call it. I can't see what the official is calling over there.
Oklahoma thinks they have the football at the 20-yard line.
I think they do.
He had to have control in the end zone. I'm talking about the defender. There's Durham. And there's Watts. A fumble. Let's see what control is in the end zone. Ball still alive.
You know, oddly enough, the ball bounced back into the field of play, into the end zone, and the last player who touched it was an Oklahoma player, and evidently they gave the ball to Oklahoma for that reason.
And Durham was wide open.
Oh, was he open? He looked like he ran off the other side of the bench.
A big play, a big turnover, and it does not go against the Oklahoma Sooners. Here it is, Hank, right here.
And they had a safety blitz, I think, what happened on it, Tom, and there was nobody there.
This looks like a 400-meter relay now. Everybody's in the line.
And watch, he gets hit from the backside. The ball bounces right into the end zone. Oklahoma has on the 20.
Shepherd with the inside handoff to Sims, Freddie Sims. No relation to Billy Sims, but sure runs good. Billy Sims, one of the great runners in football, period, whether it's collegiate or professional football, one of the great gliders that I've ever watched.
He really knows how to get in that end zone, doesn't he?
Strong, too. Second down and 5, out on the 25. Yeoman is still mad about the fumble. He'll handle it. But he isn't happy. 1:10 left in the third period. Handoff to Buster Rhymes. Being held under check rather well by the Cougar defense so far.
Well, that offensive line of the Oklahoma Sooners really getting off the ball in good shape that time again. An unbalanced line to the right. The flanker was very close that time. And they definitely had an advantage, and they took advantage of it. Third and 3.
Waiting for the wind to perhaps get out of their face. Oklahoma slowed it down. There are 40-some-odd seconds left in the third. They don't throw it that much, with the wind's going to bother them anyway. Breaking out over is Freddie Sims. He's still on his feet. Sims, breaking tackles, gets to the 50-yard line. Honor falling on him there.
Well, that's one thing about a young running back. He has it or he doesn't have it. It's very obvious. Here's a freshman, Fred Sims, 5'10", 202. And he just got great instinctive running ability along with speed. Look at the left guard, 75. Terry Crouch pulling on the play. He runs through some traffic. It makes a couple of moves, breaks some tackles. Unbelievable job of running. Good leverage, good and low. Comes out the pile to the other end and does a good job.
Byford, a big offensive right tackle, doing a good job at the point of attack. Here's Shepherd, stayed inside. He's going to go. Shepherd breaks out with some good blocking from the outside, inside the 20, and now pulled down the 10-yard line by Grady Turner. Grady Turner, his old friend from the University of Houston, when the young man went to Houston, pulled him down or he would have scored a touchdown. Look at the grin on his face.
Watch Shepherd going to the right side. Boy, number 34 does a good job. Alvin Ross, a beautiful job. Number 34 made the block. And that's what has to happen. Nothing happens by accident, by design. Good blocking at the point of attack. Good running by Shepherd. And they take the ball all the way down to the 9-yard line.
2 seconds left in this period. And the Sooners looked like they were going to be scored upon when Durham fumbled into the end zone. And they've taken it coast to coast in a very short time. The fourth quarter will get underway. Oklahoma has a 10-7 lead. We'll be back to the Sun Bowl coverage after this word from your local station.
The Sun Bowl has been sponsored by Datsun, who invite you to see all the exciting new 1982 Datsun cars and trucks at your Datsun dealer today. Smooth and mellow Michelob. And by Exxon, working on energy for you.
All right, we missed that first play. It was first and goal from the 9. Shepherd went out to the left side. Got maybe, I don't think he barely made the line of scrimmage. Good tackle there by Weedy Harris, the linebacker.
And Calvin Eason also came in from the safety position. Really did a good job too, number 38.
The full bone. The bone is in for Oklahoma and Switzer's team. Inside drive play. Fake, kept by Shepherd. Cutting back inside. Stays on his feet. Shepherd down to the 3-yard line with a great run. Great individual effort. Weedy Harris again making the tackle. He is nifty.
You talk about stretching a loss into a gain. That's exactly what he did. Darrell Shepherd, number 8 that time, got hit a couple of times, but in spite of that, kept his balance, fakes to the fullback inside, takes the ball outside. Number 44 misses the tackle. Harmon, and he fights his way through some tackles. Look at the great job of running that he does and takes the ball down to about the 3-yard line. Great job by Darrell Shepherd, number 8.
Shepherd with 101 yards now on 16 carries. Third down and 3. Inside, it's awfully close to Sims. Bangs it down near that goal line. Let's go down to Freddie Dreyer.
Well, Houston's had a lot of their own problems, and they've been the reason they haven't done very well today. If they don't get anything going offensively, the only thing they can hope for is a good defense. Their backs are against the wall now, and if they don't hold Sooners now, they're going to put somebody else in the game. And I think it's this person right here.
He's talking about Shasta, that beautiful cougar that's there. Watch your hands, Freddie. Don't get up near that cage. All right, first and goal. Quarterback sneak by Shepherd. Touchdown. The second touchdown for the Oklahoma quarterback of the day. Bechtel, the big offensive center, clear in the way. And what looked like a University of Houston touchdown, recovered fumble in the end zone, turned around, and the Sooners took it and took advantage.
Well, you talk about a boomerang play. That was surely one.
Yeoman looks like he was still trying to get a clarification from the officials. This is Keeley. Barefoot like Tony Franklin, the Eagle kicker.
The kick is up.
Like Tony Franklin, it was true. 17-7, a 10-point spread. It was knotted at halftime, 7-all. Oklahoma looks like they are getting to go to work here in the fourth period. Period. 5-1 bowl team, the Oklahoma Sooners. They own the Orange Bowl, I guess, don't they, Hank?
Yeah, they really do. And that goes way back, a long time. They've played a lot of games in the Orange Bowl.
There's Keeley's kick. It's a deep one. Zone. Don Jordan just watches it go. There's a young man that had a 53-yarder in the Orange Bowl a year ago against Florida State. Don't forget the classic as Texas locks horns with the Crimson Tide. That means Bear Bryant and, of course, Akers. It's Texas and Alabama in the Cotton Bowl. Coverage at 2 o'clock Eastern Time, 1 o'clock Central here on CBS Sports. That's on New Year's Day. The Bear. From the 20-yard line. Trailing now by 10. Lionel Wilson, the quarterback. Back to throw. Being chased, which he likes. Ooh, knocked down. Good looking little trip right at the 9.5-yard line by John Blake. The nose man. I believe it was Brian, number 80. Number 80. At 13 solo tackles against USC.
And he's limping a little bit too, Tom. He might have got a shot in the ankle or the calf or something.
Boy, that was almost a trip. In fact, that was a trip.
Yeah, it was a trip to the synthetic turf.
Jerry Dickens is in there, sophomore. Quarterback right now is Lionel Wilson. Trying to get his physical condition taken care of.
Gary Dickens.
Sidelines. They need points. The wind is in the face of the young quarterback replacement. Back inside. Good looking keeper on his first play out over the 20. That's Jerry Dickens. Whaley making the tackle.
Both teams have a lot of speed. They bring in one after another, and they all look like one's faster than the guy who just left the game.
The 191-pounder, hometown Houston, stayed right there to go to school.
What do you want?
Won more games at 76 in the Southwest Conference than any other team. That's the Cougars. It's third down and 10. The play by Dickens on the run, throwing to the left. Has Fee open. Fee at the 31-yard line draws a crowd.
You know, the defense of Oklahoma that time, both outside defensive backs were inside of Fee on the play. anticipating something on the inside, and they threw outside. He was wide open. The ball was right on the money. First down for the Houston.
A lot of people thought this would be a toss-up. Some said a 24-27 game. Lionel Wilson is back in at quarterback now. The coaches don't set odds. They just
low
coach
ball,
it.
Bro.
Right now, it's first down and 10. Good play. Lionel hands off out to the 35, Alan Pope.
That time they run a trap with right guard Bobby Grimes, number 60, trapping on the play. Came very close to breaking it clean.
In front of me.
Possibility of a big gain.
Two big offensive lines.
CBS?
Right here. That's right, on CBS, as somebody in the sideline said. They've had a lot of fun, and all the fun now will culminate if you win. Then you go home from the bowl game and say, boy, that was the best trip I ever had. Here's the reverse handoff thrown badly by Lionel Wilson. Wow, Alan Polk has it back on the 13-yard line. A big loss, an errant lateral.
And a good judgment on a part of the back, Alan Polk, that time. He did not try to pick it up. He was just satisfied to make sure that his team maintained possession. He fell on the ball and was satisfied just to have possession right there, third and six.
And Steve Whaley, number 57, the senior, was right there that forced that. And, of course, remember, Wilson has just come back off sort of a leg injury and might have thrown it a little bit prematurely. Inside drive. It's the give out to the 20-yard line. Still on his feet is Alan Pope. But a long way from the markers. And against the wind now, they will have to root the football out of there. And Oklahoma doesn't give it back much. 10 minutes left, and 10 points down.
Steve Hayworth is the deep for the Sooners.
Lonnie Stokes back to punt. Not a good kick. Right into the Oklahoma bench at about the 37-yard line. Stokes isn't happy. Yeoman's not happy. And Barry Switzer's big offense comes back on the field, 17-7. Colorado, my friend Hank Stram, of course, was the Purdue man, the Boilermaker himself, and Freddie Dreyer on the sidelines from San Diego State a few years ago, and we've gone back to college. It's 17-7 under 10 minutes left in the fourth quarter, and Oklahoma has the football in Houston territory. That's Freddie Sims, the brilliant freshman, picking up yardage. Bill Yeoman, 20 years at Houston. Seasons, over 500. That's how you last 20 years in the same school, huh?
That's right. That's how you stay ahead of the posse.
Second down at 7. Inside handoff. Freddie Sims again. Amazes me to see young people that are freshmen, 17-year-olders, playing at this level so well and with such composure. When I was a freshman, I could barely find the Arts and Science building, you know? Much less really play. I mean that.
You never had trouble finding a training table, though, did you?
No, I could always find. They didn't break my plate. I knew I had one more week. Third down and 4. Pretty tight formation. The bone is there. Three backs. Inside drive option. The weak side. Toss. Back to Buster Rhymes. Stopped at the wrong time. Right on the line of scrimmage. The Cougars really hustling on that play.
They're amazing. There are so few penalties in this game, Tom. Isn't it?
Tops we've seen about 3 or 4, and most of those were illegal procedure. Shepherd, a very busy young person right there. Back in Texas, but only for a short time. He grew up in Odessa. Keeley now will try the field goal. Remember, he had a 42-yarder this year and a 53-yarder a year ago. This will be from the 39, so it's a 49-yarder. Wow. Boy, that would have carried. That one did go almost to the ambulance out of the end zone. What a kick. 20-7. That would have been good from 65.
He kicked it right up into the tunnel that time. A beautiful kick.
20-7. Oklahoma getting Saturday. All starts with the NFL today, of course, but Tampa Bay goes against Dallas at Texas Stadium. And, of course, next Sunday, either Philadelphia or New York Giants, out of that wild card playoff that's going to happen tomorrow, will go against the San Francisco 49ers and, of course, the coach of the year, Mr. Walsh. Sunday, January the 10th, the championship game of the NFC. And, of course, January 24th at Pontiac, Silverdome, Super Bowl 16.
Imagine Bill Walsh done some kind of a job with those 49ers.
He really has. He's a great coachy. There always was. You were a great coach. Inside handoff. Now, Lionel Wilson going across the middle. Misses Mark Ford by a lot, and that's hard. Yeoman now getting a little bit desperate.
Yeah, one thing that's really been a problem for Houston, Tom, they haven't had good field position. They've been in the oatmeal most of the time, taking a ball in the 20. They're 20. One time at the 50, but they've had bad field position most of the time in the second half.
And Oklahoma, of course, got the big turnover. He earned that with good hustling play. They even covered the fumble in the end zone and got it out of there. Scored right afterward. There's Franklin, Patrick Franklin, who might be the fastest player in all of football right now. He's the young man that ran the 9200. He ran a 10-300 meters in high school at Bay City, Texas. And he's a 212-pounder. Can you imagine that speed? 9-2.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Houston with only 5 out-of-state players. Right now the wind is picking up in the face of Lionel Wilson, the young quarterback. Third down and 7. He's got some time. Wilson out in the flat. That's Jordan with the football. Jordan gets to the 36-yard line. A good play by Lionel Wilson, the young quarterback. Made sure his formation was right and then delivered the football.
Yeah, and Tom Benson, that time, number 38, had a good shot at him, but he ducked right underneath and went right over the top and missed the tackle.
A first and 10. Removed the stick. 7:05 on the clock. 20-7 now. Oklahoma suddenly came out in the second half and broke that 7-all tie wide open. Lionel Wilson inside. Handoff now. Toss back. Fumble. And Oklahoma has the football. Alan Polk could not get the option lateral put away, and Whaley came up with it. The senior linebacker, very quick, and he's been out there all day cutting off that outside game for Houston.
Here we see it again. Wilson going down the line of scrimmage, tosses the ball a little bit too far out in front. And for that reason, Polk wasn't able to get the handle on it and fumbles. Oklahoma has possession on the plus 30.
7 minutes left. Oklahoma with the big lead now and the football. Boy, it's tough. Early, somebody moved or maybe drew him off. Terry Monroe came with the big shiver that time. Gave Terry Crouch, the All-American, a headache. Crouch, a giant at 6'1", 275. All-American for 2 years.
Offside. Offense.
The offense moved a little bit and drew him off. 7 minutes left, a 20-7 lead, and it's first and 15. Shepard with the full boat. Inside drive, and he gives it to Freddie Sims. Fred Dreyer on the sidelines. Come in, please.
Hi, guys.
All right.
You know what's exciting about this? I'm getting paid to sit here and look at all these beautiful girls. And right with me here, I have, who do we have? We have the queen, don't we?
Janine Costa.
My Sun Queen. Janine Costa.
Where are you from, dear?
I'm from El Paso. I was born and raised here.
I thought you were an SMU fan.
Well, I go to school at SMU, but my heart's in El Paso.
What happened to the SMU Mustangs?
Oh, we got caught cheating, I guess.
Too bad. Back to you guys.
All right, Freddie Sims was not caught. He just scored a touchdown with a great run. He's keeping the ball. He's only a freshman. He may have a house that's going to look like a sporting goods place. He's going to have a lot of footballs on the mantle.
Yeah, a lot of trophies. Boy, he really popped through there clean as a whistle. Fred Sims, number 23 from Tucson. There you see him going through a nice hole. Breaks into the open and goes into the end zone unmolested for the touchdown. What a run.
133 yards on 12 carries, all in the second half. This is Keeley now, who's getting a workout. He bangs it. And it's good. Young Sims carrying a name like he means it.
To the left side, he raises a block. The left guard, Terry Crouch, number 75, really does a good job of blocking the defensive tackle. He reads the block, good vision, good eyes, pops into the clear, goes into the end zone for the touchdown. Beautiful run, Fred Sims.
You know, Bill Yeoman was saying that it looks like the Oklahoma bone looks very simple, but it's not really. He said it's a very sophisticated thing, and the blocking angles and all they set up really make some of the runs look rather easy sometimes, don't they?
Yes, and of course the key really is a quarterback reads. He has to read the defensive tackle, the defensive end, whoever it might be, and he has to exercise the right judgment, give the ball to the fullback or keep it and toss it back or keep it himself. It's a very intricate system, and they've done a very sophisticated job with it.
All right, Keating kicking off. Jordan will wait for it. This is a fairly short kick taken at the 10-yard line by Wiggins. Back out over the 25. 6:15 left, and the Cougars haven't scored in the second half. Don't forget, following the Sun Bowl, Louisville against DePaul. Louisville finished off last season with 15 straight wins, if I remember, and of course, Ray Myers always has the crazy demons, the Blue Demons, ready to go. Billy Packer and Gary Bender at courtside right after the Sun Bowl here in El Paso. There's Barry Switzer. Boy, was he cooperative. And he really came because Jim Rogers and Johnny Fulmer just kept after him for years to bring Oklahoma to El Paso, and the players love it. Mark Ford making the catch, but not for much yardage.
The players involved in the game, they've been bragging about what a great time they've had. They've enjoyed going to bowl games, and they said this is one of the most enjoyable ones they've ever attended.
How about the other day when Scott got up and sang, and young Shepherd was playing the drums? He's a good drummer.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun to see these kids perform. You know, unfortunately, we didn't have to get the hook for any of them. They're all pretty good.
That's right. Most of them are so big, I wouldn't want to put a hook on either any of them.
Well, the hook wouldn't get them off the floor anyhow, I don't think.
They're measuring to see now as they bring it all the way across the field. Some of the people have decided to go stretch a little bit, probably outside in the sunshine here at El Paso.
They're escaping from the premises.
6:08 left in the fourth period of the 47th annual Sun Bowl.
And that really, the wind has really kicked up. It was very modest before the game, but it's really blowing hard now.
Yeah, there's a unhappy coach on one side, and of course, Switzer's very much used to winning. And when they do at Oklahoma. Reversed by Lionel Wilson, going outside. It's his receiver who gets away from somebody at the 45. That's Roberson making the catch. He's got the speed, too.
Yeah, you know, they really, it's tough to throw into that wind, but they have to really make some kind of a big play to get back into this game. They can't do it by taking what they're being given. They've got to get the ball in that middle area to make some kind of a big play, Tom.
Yeoman and Switzer were laughing about everybody in the pros going to the shotgun. They said, that's a sissy offense. Nobody goes to the shotgun. They say when they used to do it, people used to boo in the stands. Straightaway drive. Donald Jordan's in there now.
I guarantee you they never booed in the Southwest Conference with Matty Bell and Dan Abible and Dutch Meyer and all those people ran to spread formation with Sammy Ball and
Freddie Benners and that bunch.
You're right. They brought a lot of folks to the stadium. And how about little Davey O'Brien?
That's right. I think Meredith even played the shotgun some, didn't he?
Oh, sure.
He may have made up plays in the huddle, probably. Dan DeRue did.
Yeah.
First and 10 now. The toss back as Wilson is going to keep it himself and throws it into the rug, intended for Mark Ford.
Well, remember the time Freddie Benner threw, I think, 50 passes against Ohio State and won the Ohio State, I forget what year it was, like 1950.
And that one year they beat Notre Dame. Remember when Hart and that bunch went in with Notre Dame and SMU with Kyle Rode and Doak Walker and a couple of good players?
Yeah, I think that was like 49.
It was before my time, but I remember reading about it.
Yeah, before mine, too.
Second down and 10. The ball's in the 48. A 27-7 score. Oklahoma's come out and really put it to the Cougars in the second half. Here's the straight drop back out of the fake. A little play action. Pretty good throw on the outside, but it's away. Fee can't get to it. And if he can't, it is wide of the mark. Remember, Lionel Wilson is a sophomore. Please keep that in mind.
You know, Linnell Fee, you have to be impressed with that little rascal. He's really played a very good football game. He dances every dance, plays all the time, did a good job of blocking on the outside. He's not very large, 5'10", 167. But he can fly and he can play.
And most of the outside receivers that people are going for, since you can't bump them in the pros, can be smaller.
Yeah, as long as they can run fast.
Remember, this game is for recruiting rights of Texas and other places. Good looking throw and a good catch at the 40-yard line. I believe that's Roberson that made that catch. No, it was Field to the right side. No, it was Roberson on that side. The sophomore, 184 pounds.
Ball now resting on the Oklahoma 40.
4:59 the clock, under 5 minutes.
You know, Tom, I'm surprised they don't have some kind of reverse or some kind of misdirection play the way these teams chase. Some kind of a reverse would be very successful, wouldn't you think?
I would think so. Here's coming out now. This is just a rollout, and Wilson isn't about to give it up. This side the 35 and out of bounds, which will stop the clock. But not pick up that much yardage.
Boy, Alan Polk made a great block, number 32, on the linebacker or the defensive end on the outside. Really a terrific block.
What happened at halftime, do you suppose, other than, of course, the big turnover really turned the game around on the fumble recovered in the end zone for a touchback?
Yeah, but really the big difference, you know, Oklahoma's had much better field position. Houston has not had good field position the entire second half and started every drive on the 20-yard line with the exception of the one they got in the 50.
Good handoff. A big hole opened up as Patrick Franklin got through there so quickly. And if that wasn't a real good tackle, the speedster might have gotten loose. Bryan laid it on him. All Big Eight as a sophomore. Number 80 is going to be around for a while. I remember my old coach, Dal Ward, you know, in those days at halftime when we'd go in college, and I'm trying to think back. He used to just give us that reevaluate yourself, son, you know. What are you guys doing now? Get back to your game plan. Start thinking.
And look in the mirror.
Yeah, that was always scary anyway. I was scared to death about half of my college career, I think. First and 10 on the 27. Houston driving, but they're trailing. Good throw on the run to Mark Ford. Quite a receiver. Most tight ends in college don't get that much action. He's been quite a plus for Yeoman.
Yeah, and he came into the game with 29 receptions, and Fee came in with 40. Not bad for a team that doesn't throw the ball that much.
That's right. The hometown, Mena, Arkansas. That's right next to Inc., Arkansas. He says they got 25 people in town, and the big town is Mena, which is down the road.
And how far is that from Penn, Arkansas? Huh?
Small town. Good country boys make good football players sometimes. Here we go inside. That's Franklin. Man, can he run to the 15-yard line. 6'1", 212. Ran a 10-300 meters. That used to be the world's record. He did that as a senior in high school. Switzer would like to take him home with him. back to Norman.
Well, Switzer ought to be pretty pleased with the guy he's got, Fred Sims, the way he's going to this afternoon.
Big programs and great institutions. If you don't go to class, you can't play. It's as simple as that. Donald Jordan straight ahead. Time running out now. A 20-point deficit, which was a 7-7 tie at half. And Yeoman's going to be wondering about that fumble recovery right now. These fellows won't.
No, they're full of happiness.
They're going to stay over to the CV and then go back tomorrow, back to Norman. They just got through with exams. Maybe that's the reason they're so happy.
They must have all passed the way they played.
They did today. 3.5 minutes left. Lionel giving off inside. Lionel Wilson to Alan Polk.
You know, it's fun. You have to admire both coaches. They have a philosophy, a strong belief in what they're doing. And they don't care about anything else than what anybody else says, what everybody feels. They do their thing. They have a philosophy. They execute the philosophy. They've been very, very successful. And you like to see people who have those kind of strong convictions about what they do.
You know, it's fun to see the guys that have graduated and gone on and come back. They're solid citizens, and it makes it worthwhile, doesn't it?
Well, it certainly does. Good people.
Third down and 3, they're down in the 6. Wilson tossing back. Wow. Standing up. Donald Jordan scores the 200-pounder, the sophomore. And I mean, it was tossed back and it was over as soon as the toss went out. A good option play by Lionel Wilson.
Well, they made that one look just like they draw it up on the blackboard. A good ride inside by Wilson.
tosses the ball outside to Jordan, who goes untouched for the touchdown. Good-looking play.
You know, Don Ivory, the young assistant coach for Houston, told me he recruited Lionel Wilson. And by telling him that you're not going to play halfback, you're going to be our quarterback. And he said, well, maybe I'd like to be a quarterback, but he could play a running back. He's a very fine athlete.
Yeah, and everybody else felt that they were going to use him as a halfback. I think he was impressed with the fact that he could play quarterback.
Sure. Glendenning's kick is good. It's suddenly 27-14. What about the most valuable players in this Sun Bowl?
Most valuable player, Darrell Shepard, the Oklahoma quarterback, and the most valuable lineman, Ricky Bryan, Oklahoma defensive tackle.
Well, that's good, though. Of course, young Shep got the two touchdowns rushing to get him off the Snyder. Don't forget, following Louisville against DePaul, Myers against Crum. That's right after this football game, live from Rosemont, Illinois. Billy Packer and Gary Bender, the old fender bender for NCAA basketball here on CBS, right after the Sun Bowl. Some good athletes in that college baskets, too. 2:55 left, 27-14. Now we're looking for an onside kick of some kind, or what are you going to do with it?
Oh, they got an onside kick it.
Looks like they've drawn up into the, got the infield in close. At least Oklahoma's moved some people up. That restraining line is the 50, and they're up.
They got the baseball gloves on everybody up front, so they scoop it up one of those hot grounders.
Barefooted. There, it's over the 10 yards. It's a live potato, and it's taken by Oklahoma, the 42-yard line. I believe Watts, the secondary man, fell on.
Never seen an onside kick, but I'm not reminded of the great play Bobby Bell made against Denver one year. They tried an onside kick. He caught it in the first hop and scooted in for the touchdown before you could say Jack Robinson.
As you said earlier, Hank, there's the MVP, Darrell Shepard, the quarterback. There he is, the man that made the All-Big Eight squad as a sophomore. More individual tackles than anybody else in the conference. From Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Rick Bryan, congratulations, young people from OU, and the game looks like it's yours. You have the football and a 27-14 lead. Remember when Tommy McDonald played at Oklahoma? He started that hurry-up for Bud Wilkinson when they would, you didn't know if he was fumbling or running back to the huddle.
Oh, could he fly?
Became a great teammate of mine with the Eagles, and he and Van Brocklin sort of carried the birds around for a couple of years. We ended up sort of snitching a national title in the NFL. Wilson is 17 for 26 for 216 yards passing. No touchdowns. But he has thrown the football as advertised.
They're going to do it again. Try the outside kick again, Thomas.
All right, this time from the 45, which means that Oklahoma was over the restraining line probably. Ball is blowing toward the Mexican border.
They're going to have somebody hold it or else put a spike in the end of the ball and nail it in.
Freddie Dreyer, we've lost communications with our friend on the sidelines. His last interview was with the Queen of the Sun Bowl. All right, the onside kick. Uh-oh, the holder doesn't know where to stand because the sidewinder is trying to find a way he can kick it. Oh, he's going to use his left foot. Does. Doesn't go the 10 yards, I don't believe. Now there's going to be a penalty on that. This keeps on. We better tell them to hold our flight. We're not going to make the flight to Philadelphia. There's the MVP offensive player, Darrell Shepard. Transferred from the University of Houston to Oklahoma. He said he loved Houston. It was no problem, but due to the NCAA violations that somebody dreamed up, he wasn't allowed to play in bowl games, and he's going to do that at Oklahoma. All his friends are on the other side. That may be some little get-together they have tonight, huh?
Yeah, they'll have a lot of fun.
2:54 left, 27-14. Inside handoff and not much. It's Freddie Sims, who has been outstanding in the second half. Kelly Phelps is the quarterback. 5'10", 183-pound junior. When you're in college, though, the tradition not only helps you recruiting, but that's what you're really building when you're going to bowls. You're promising the young guys, if we can, if we play well, we'll go to a bowl.
You know the impressive thing about the pro players we had at Kansas City, people came from good programs. Boy, they had a great look at this.
That's Freddie Sims. Shepard better get that game ball. This kid's going to steal a trophy from him here.
Yeah, we might have to vote over again. Gee, what a great-looking run again by Sims.
I just have a feeling you're going to see he and Stanley Wilson in the same backfield. He looks to be like he could play halfback, doesn't he?
Boy, can he move and make adjustments, and he came through that hole. It looked like he was going to be stopped at the line of scrimmage and popped right through there and made the big gain on the play.
Sims is a roadrunner from Tucson, as you mentioned. He must have had 9,000 yards in high school. I can't imagine trying to tackle him.
I wonder how many pairs of shoes he wore.
Here's the full wishbone inside. That's Sims again. No cigar, not this time. A little over 2 minutes left. On a day for two good college football teams from two great institutions. It's a lot of fun to see Wade Walker, the AD at Oklahoma.
Yeah, I played golf with Wade yesterday and had a lot of fun.
Did you get any of his cash, or did you play together?
No, we were partners.
Well, that figures, knowing you and Wade.
And we emerged triumphant.
Barry Switzer, energetic, but he wants to win. It's a touchdown. That is Ronnie Mills getting the dive play off the bone off the left side with 1:30 left. Well, varsity did a pretty good job, and suddenly the JVs are beginning to lay it on. It's 33-14. Here it is, Hank.
Straight ahead. Good shot. Good surge on the left side again. Ed Culver, Terry Crouch, left guard, left tackle, respectively, do a good job of making something happen up front, and he goes in for the touchdown.
Here's Keeley's extra point tackle. Oop, hits the goalpost, bounces back, and is almost fair caught. That's no good. It's about the first thing that's happened wrong against Oklahoma.
Either that or else you look at it as a very positive thing. It's very accurate. It's hard to hit that upright like it is. You got to be pretty accurate.
We want to thank our producer, Robert Stinner, and I see Bobby and Bob Dumphy, our very fine director, Bob Rowe. Tommy O'Neill has been down there with Freddie Drouin at sidelines. Philip Wilson, Steve Cunningham. You can see the team picture there, Jimmy Ripple. Yes, we have spent Christmas in El Paso, Texas. I want to thank everybody. And they're the people that are behind the scenes.
You'd win big with that team, wouldn't you?
Man, I'll tell you. You got to win the toss when you got that group. Merry Christmas. Feliz Navidad, as they say down here.
Yeah, and thanks a lot for all the help to make this such a great telecast.
Johnny Hogue is kicking off out of the end zone. Marty Robbins in the background. It always does, doesn't it? Seen so many old friends down here. This is one of the friendliest places you'll ever come. Sometimes get in your camper and drive from wherever you are and see what it's like. 1:30 left, a 33-14 Oklahoma edge, or bulges in this case, down the middle, incomplete. Fee was the intended receiver. Hank, it's been a lot of fun working with you.
Yeah, enjoyed it very much, Tom.
Yeah, we get together once in a while, and we're like a team, too, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really been a lot of fun. You make it very easy, Tom.
The land of
thank
the
you.
Enchilada. Yeah, thank you. 1:26 left. Lionel Wilson had a big day passing, but can't get those points. Oh, that's Johnny Truitt. Oklahoma rolling now. Johnny Truitt, the sophomore. The left end or linebacker, if you will. Johnny Truitt. 6-3-2-0-1. And the defense scores. Remember, he's the young man that came from the same place that Stanley Wilson came from, Carson, California.
Play action pass. Here we go. Wilson throwing. Watch it. It's deflected. And John Truitt, number 41, makes the interception, scampers down the sideline. inserts the ball in the end zone. Another touchdown, Oklahoma.
It's another thing Oklahoma's had a few of. Linebackers, huh?
Oh, and they had some great linebackers.
Schoat, Cumby. Of course, before that, Jerry Tubbs. Some great people, great linebackers. And what a job. Oklahoma, from a 7-7 tie, has blown it open, offensively and defensively. The red shirts just down for the trip. The young people for Oklahoma will play perhaps next year. What about the young man Dent that was the guard that had the operation and all? A very inspirational thing, don't you think, Hank?
Yeah, no question about that. Very emotional scene at the luncheon the other day, but he certainly had to be a great football player and a great human being. They're going to have
Don Key. Don Key.
That's right.
He had a serious operation, will never play football again, but Barry Switzer said he will not only be on the staff at Oklahoma, but he will also have an award named for him for being the inspirational kind of young person he wants his football people to be. Don Key. I like the way Switzer did that. I thought that was out of sight. Okay, here's Holt kicking off. Taken at the 2-yard line by Donald Jordan. He's got some running room. Look out. 25-yard line. 40-14.
Well, we never thought it was going to be this kind of a game, did we, Tom?
Boy, I'll tell you. I thought 3 points either way. I think that's really what both coaches thought, too, from what we could gather.
Well, listen, watching them on our TV program, they asked what kind of a game it was going to be, high scoring or low scoring. And I think Bill Yeoman said, well, I think any time we say it's going to be a low scoring game, it winds up being a high scoring game and vice versa. And that's so true. I've done the same thing many times.
Switzer was laughing on that same television show, and he said, we lead the whole world in fumbles. He said, if we don't fumble, we have a chance to win this game. Donald Jordan carrying. And Dickens, of course, is the young quarterback in now. Lionel Wilson worked hard and long. And that young defense that has sort of been maligned for Oklahoma has played extremely well. Because this offense for the Cougars has been rather impressive against some real good defensive clubs throughout the year. That was Patrick Fragrant, the sprinter.
And another thing that Barry said the other day was very significant here this afternoon. They said, if we don't lay the ball on the turf, why, we can beat anybody, and they did a pretty good job of not doing that this afternoon.
We'd like to acknowledge some of the people here that we haven't mentioned that always make the Sun Bowl so much fun for us. Janie Thornton, of course, our lovely lady who is the chairman for this Sun Bowl, and of course she's been fun. Tommy Starr, Johnny Fulmer, who follows these teams all over the country. I don't know how he makes all the schedules. Sam Jenkins, Sandy Sanders, of course, our big boot man. Jan Wheeler, and of course, Jimmy Rogers. And as we said, this is not an assignment to come here for CBS. It's a true pleasure. Young Dickens, number 20.
The El Paso Herald sponsors this award. And the most valuable lineman has been awarded.
Dickens, did you get a taste of that mariachi music around the hotel a little bit?
Yeah, I did a little. So watch everybody trot around a little bit. Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
There's some pro prospects right there. Don't forget, following this game, immediately following this Sun Bowl Classic, we got some round ball action, and I mean the best. NCAA basketball, Louisville against DePaul, live from Illinois. I wonder if it's cold up there. Wherever you are, we hope that your day has been somewhat warmed and made mellow because of what you're going to see on CBS. Here's Fee, going to throw a pass off the end around and throws a real bullet to the 40-yard line. That's Roberson, his counterpart, the outside flanker, who caught it. Fee threw a pretty good pass.
Yes, he did. Yeah, we talked about the reverse. They finally got one in and then threw a pass from
him. Well, you and I are getting ready for that flight back east. I got to get taped up tomorrow in case I have to play for the Eagles. I'm going to be in the stands like a normal person.
You'll have those low cuts on ready to go, Tom. I know that.
Well, it'll be cold and bitter, but tomorrow, don't forget the wild card shot. The Eagles, who won the NFC a year ago, and have had their problems until last Sunday against the New York Giants. And those Giants, that defensive team will crawl all over you.
Yeah, the Ray Perkins and his staff really done a good job with that football team the way they started and came on strong. And like you say, boy, they've done a terrific job defensively.
The Oklahoma running back, the young man Freddie Sims, 181 yards rushing. That's the third highest individual rushing total in Sun Bowl history. Charlie Alexander from LSU at 197. Walter Packer at 183 and 74, but Sims did it in one half a play. Well, if he ever could play four quarters, he might set a few marks that would last. That's it. Oklahoma with a second half rush beat the Houston Cougars 40-14. This is Tom Brookshire for...